to condemn him. If Mazin Nandekan did not say anything, why are you judging Uchemefor? What if they settle tomorrow? Prince Darlington, you are evil. Prince Darlington, you are doing more damage than good. Prince Darlington, what you are doing, the enemies are laughing at us. All of you that are speaking against Uchemefor, when Mazin Nandekan have not spoken against him, you all are an enemy of Biafra. This is the word of the people that we are furnishing with correct and accurate information. This is the word of the people that we are gathering information of what is happening behind the scene, bringing it to them via this channel, and they are castigating us, they are calling us names. The same thing that happened in the Bible, because I always use the Bible that I read to tell you what is happening because of those that believe in the scripture. When Moses went to save the people of Israel out of the land of Egypt, on their way, when they were going, so many people were castigating him. People are calling him names. They were saying, Mr. Moses, why are you doing this to us? Why did you allow us to stay there? Why did you bring out of that land? Now we are suffering in the wilderness because of their stupidity, because of their stubbornness. The journey that's supposed to take them 40 days, they spent 40 years. And this is the same people that we are dishing information to, the same people we are passing information to, the same people we are trying to give all the important details that they should be able to know what is happening, so they will know the right and the left, their right and the left, which one to follow. But these same people keep on insulting us, keep on calling us name, waiting to hear from Mazin and Kano. I don't blame some of you. The reason why I don't blame some of you is because we have not done freedom fighting before. We have not done freedom fighting before. This is the first time we are doing freedom fighting, and a lot of you that just joined this struggle, you heard that there is a movement called Indigenous People of Biafra Movement for Biafra Restoration. You jump in. You don't know anything. You don't have any idea of what is happening on the ground. You don't have any iota of idea of what is playing inside. And it's not everything that you, some of you that doesn't know what is happening, should be expecting Mazin Nandekan to come and be telling you. But on this morning program, you are here what happened. Exactly what happened before now. Because any organization or movement, there are supposed to be misunderstanding, even in family, even in churches. If in heaven that devil will rebel against God, according to the same Bible we are reading, if devil can rebel against God, the creator of heaven and earth, who are you to think that Uchemefor cannot rebel against Mazin Nandekan? If devil can rebel against God, and there was war in heaven, the Bible recorded that there's war in heaven. And when that war broke out, there are some angels that followed devil. There are some angels that followed devil. Some of angels followed devil to rebel against God. Some of them. And they ganged up. I want you to know that according to the scripture, that war happened and God had to chase devil out from heaven, then to the earth. That is the scripture that I'm telling you what happened there. Okay? Now, this fight is not a fight that just started under 1 second. It is something that has been happening for a very long time. And when God said, no, I cannot hold it anymore. I cannot condone it anymore. I cannot handle it anymore. It is time for you to leave this kingdom. And what happened? Devil also have his own gang that follows him. Just like Obido Bienu, who is following Mazuche before. Just like Obido Bienu, who have deceived Uche before. And so many of them that I don't want to mention their name yet. Until when time comes, I will give you people the list of all the people that worked with Uche before and planned this evil. Obido Bienu is the number one person. So Obido Bienu is the number one person that is behind Uche before to believe, to work with what is happening on the ground. And most of you, I want to correct one impression here. Most of you that are from Anambra State, you are playing game with the national issue. This issue has nothing to do with I am from Idemili, I am from Anambra, I am from Enugu, I am from Abia. No. This is a national issue. We are talking about the people of Biafra, not the people of Idemili or people of Anambra. So if you are taking side because Uchemefor is from Idemili and the Obidobian is from Idemili, then you get out because you don't know what you are doing. You don't know what you are doing. I have seen how this game is, how you people are playing this game. I have seen it. I remember when some court boys went and scattered our women meeting in at Oba. I remember what Mazinand can say. Mazinand can wanted to unleash mayhem on them, but he said, because of one person, because of Obidobienu, I am going to tamper justice with mercy. Because he acknowledged that the WWN is from there. But right now, all of you that are siding with him for clapping hand, condemning Mazinand Kanu, saying all sorts of nonsense, I challenge you, we that are giving you the information as in the heart. Because WWN is from Anambra, because WWN is from Idemili. All of you that are saying that we should not talk about Uchemefor because you are from Idemili and Uchemefor is from Idemili, because from you are from Anambra and Uchemefor is from Anambra, Biafra supersedes everybody. It compasses everything and daring that has to do with Biafra. So if you are supporting Maz Uchemefor because you are from Anambra, because you think that we don't that Uchemefor is not supposed to he resigned, that you are not supposed to talk about him or what he have done, then you have to get out because you don't know what you are saying. I must tell you the truth. I must tell you the truth. As in the heart, that is how we used to do it here. And I'm going to open my line. When I open my line, you are going to call. When you call, you are going to tell us what you know or what you feel when you are done listening to the voice note that I'm going to play on this platform. When I am done playing this voice note, some of you will go and bury your faces in shame. Some of you will wish that the ground will also open for you to jump in and die. Yes, because of all the evil that you have coughed out from your mouth, because of all the nonsense, including those that are beating their chest from Germany. Hey, how we break a leg? How we break a head? How we do this? I've suffered. How we do this? Hey, if Mazinand Kanu cannot find 100 men, what about the people that have died? What about Uche before? All those people who we are singing praises for Mazinand Kanu yesterday, saying fuck all the haters of Mazinand Kanu today. They are also the people who are talking against him. So, but I don't have any problem with that. Where I have problem is when you are dumb, coughing nonsense from your mouth. And you come to know the truth. Will you also come out and say you are sorry? Because all of you wanted to do what? All of you wanted to do what? All of you wanted to, you know, be noticed as freedom fighters. Any insult or Mazinand Kanu, I block you. Once I block you, you are gone. Once I block you, you are gone. Any insult against Mazinand Kanu on this platform, I block you. I just block one idiot now. Oyofemi Manukola or Esaya. That is by the way. So my brothers and my sisters, welcome to this program. As in the hope, Nasa they bring and give you. Once again, my name remains Mazi or Eleze Chukwubike. But before I go further, I would also like you to listen to what Mazinand Kanu say. I would like you to listen to what Mazinand Kanu have told us. That man, if after this program you don't respect that man, then I will know that you don't have common sense. Then I will know that you are a devil. You are a devil incarnate. Ekwensu Durimegi. Mazinand Kanu have warned us against what is happening now. And now I want you to hear it. When you listen to him, then I will now come to the main business of the day. I won't take too much time. Once I'm done playing all the recorded voice note that I want to play for you, then I do a little analysis, then I open my line. We have come for Biafra, that Biafra shall be restored. That is why we are here. I have said it. Once you come, you call Mazinand Kanu name or insult him, you are gone. You can't come to this platform again. Listen, and listen very good, my fellow Biafrans. I want you to listen. Just listen, because it is time to begin to
open. You don't know what it means. Most of us do not understand what it means to be a Biafran. You have not seen heaven yet. I was kidnapped. I was beaten. I was spat at. My clothes were ripped from my body. Women urinated and poured it on me because of Biafra, so that they may humiliate me to such a point that I will not talk about Biafra anymore. They videoed me. Masob has a video of me where they were beating me, dragging me on the floor, tearing my clothes because I spoke the truth. That did not stop me from talking about Biafra. It did not stop me from taking Radio Biafra to Enugu. It did not stop me from broadcasting Radio Biafra from Nnewi. It did not stop me from broadcasting Radio Biafra from Onitsha, from Owerri, from Aba, from Port Harcourt. I am resolute. I don't retreat. Never. Nigeria has put me in detention before. Solitary confinement. It did not stop me from preaching Biafra. How about an imbecile, some we are talking? How can that affect me? If those that kidnapped me and nearly killed me did not stop me from doing Biafra, how about an imbecile hiding somewhere? People must know who I am. I am destructively stubborn. You see, Biafra is going to come.
Yes, I know you have listened to that. That is the voice of Mazen Nnamdi Kanu. He was narrating what has happened to him, the pains he has passed through in the struggle because of you and I, because of our freedom. Can Uche Mefo make a video or an audio to tell us the pains he has passed through in this struggle? But I will sit here to count more than 20 things that Uche Mefo have benefited from the struggle. No single loss, no single pain. Uche Mefo have not gone to the prison. He have never been arrested. His village have never been ransacked. His father's house have never been shattered. He have never been beaten. Nobody have snapped Uche Mefo naked and post on Facebook. Nobody have beaten Uche Mefo. Uche Mefo have not lost the mother in the struggle. He didn't lose the father in the struggle. He didn't lose the sister in the struggle. Uche Mefo is not declared wanted in the struggle, and he is yet the deputy. But if I enjoy for who is defending Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, his house was shattered, burnt down. A whole village was shattered and burnt down. People were shot, people were killed. Now I want you to listen to Mazen Nnamdi Kanu again before I go into the main deal. Because why I am speaking to you, I want this, his comment, this thing that he said before now, to keep ringing bell into the mindset, into the subconscious mind of you that is listening. I want you to keep ringing bell. If you close your eyes, you'll be hearing it. If you open your eye, you'll be hearing it. When you're eating your food, you'll be hearing it. When you are sitting down, you'll be hearing it. When you're in your bedroom taking your shower, you'll be hearing it. This is exactly what I want as a person. And that is why I'm going to play it for the second time. Listen to it.
You don't know what it means. Most of us do not understand what it means to be a Biafran. You have not seen anything yet. I was kidnapped. I was beaten. I was spat at. My clothes were ripped from my body. Women urinated and poured on me because of Biafra, so that they may humiliate me to such a point that I will not talk about Biafra anymore. They videoed me. Masop has a video of me where they were beating me, dragging me on the floor, tearing my clothes because I spoke the truth. That did not stop me from talking about Biafra. It did not stop me from taking Radio Biafra to Enugu. It did not stop me from broadcasting Radio Biafra from Nnewi. It did not stop me from broadcasting Radio Biafra from Onitsha, from Owerri, from Aba, from Port Harcourt. I am resolute. I don't retreat. Never. Nigeria has put me in detention before. Solitary confinement. It did not stop me from preaching Biafra. How about an imbecile, some we are talking? How can that affect me? If those that kidnapped me and nearly killed me did not stop me from being Biafra. How about an imbecile hiding somewhere? People must know who I am. I am destructively stubborn. You see, Biafra is going to come.
You see, thank you. Now that you have listened for the second time, I am now going to go into the real business of the day. And after listening to this voice, I want you to pay attention because I'm not going to play it twice. If you want to listen to it again, then after the program, you go and download it or you go and listen to it. I want you to listen and listen very, very, very carefully. If somebody is distracting you, it is the time you tell the person to please allow you because you want to pay attention to this truth that you need to hear about the matter between Mazen Nnamdi Kanu and Uchenna. All of you that wanted to know what is happening, all of you that wanted to hear the voice of Mazen Nnamdi Kanu to tell you the side of his own story, I want you to listen to this Reverend Father or what is needed again. I will get it right. This Reverend Father that you're about to hear his name now is a Reverend Father residing in the United States of America, one of the coordinators of this movement, a Catholic. If we should follow it the way it is, and why Uchenna is fighting Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, one of the reasons why Uchenna is fighting Mazen Nnamdi Kanu is fighting Mazen Nnamdi Kanu because Mazen Nnamdi Kanu is always hitting hard on the statue of Virgin Mary and Jesus that people are bowing down to, which is against the scripture written in the book of Exodus chapter 20 that Mazen Nnamdi Kanu always preach about. When Mazen Nnamdi Kanu come online and say, "I am here for Arose, I am not bowing down to any graven image," Uchenna is pained, Uchenna is crying, Uchenna is gnashing his teeth, Uchenna is always feeling like he is the Pope. But this man that you want to hear himself, his voice now, who have detailed what happened between Mazen Nnamdi Kanu and Uchenna and how they tried to form a group that will settle it, a resolution group that will settle the case, and what Mazen Nnamdi Kanu said and what Uchenna said. This man is a Reverend Father ordained, and this man, my respect for you increases to the brim today. I respected you for the first time I heard your voice, but today, after hearing your voice, my respect for you went to the brim, because irrespective of who you are or whatever you are doing, you put Biafra first and you are saying the truth, because the truth is only the weapon that will set us free. Anything apart from this truth, we cannot see Biafra. That is why the God Chukwuka Biama is separating the saboteurs among us, keeping them by the side while we move forward. Biafra doesn't need multitude to be restored. Biafra needs people that are refined with truth and honesty. Biafra needs to be restored with men and women of honor. Biafra needs people of dignity, people whiter than snow. These are the people that Biafra is looking for. And once Biafra got that number of people that is looking for, you all will see Biafra in our presence. Mazen Nnamdi Kanu told us that he needs 100 men. You people did not understand it. You guys did not understand the meaning of "I need 100 men." You are seeing "I need 100 men" as a different thing altogether. But today, I want you to listen. And I want you to share this program to the end of the world. Because I want to shame all the people that have been calling me names, saying, "President, you are doing harm, you are doing this, you are causing, you are talking about which before." You listen to this Reverend Father who's supposed to, if I should follow it according to how which before is reacting, because Mazen Nnamdi Kanu is telling the world that we don't worship any idol, we don't bow down to any idol. Because of that, he's fighting, he's crying. Then this Reverend Father should be the first person that will stand with which before. But on this particular note, I respect him. Listen to him. When you are done listening to him, I will open the line. Then you will call. Those of you that have been saying a lot of nonsense that want to hear from Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, you will hear exactly what happened and how Uchemefo disrespected everybody and went ahead and carried out his razor blade cutting, because he said he was going to cut us deep. Now he is cutting, forgetting that God put something in our body, in our body system, that fight against any cuts in our body. When you get cut, the medicine you apply on it doesn't heal it. God has placed in your body, your body's system. There's something in that is in your body that God created and put into you that heals all the cuts that you have. Whenever you have injury and it's cut open, it heals itself from inside. It is God that made it so. So Uchemefo did not remember that there are people, there is something that is in us that God deposited before he tell us he's going to cut us. So why he is cutting us, what Chukwukebewa put inside us is busy healing us. The only medicine you put on it is just to make sure that it did not contact external disease. I have not come here to make you happy. I have not come here to speak to you, to clap for me or to like me. I have come here to speak the truth as it hurt. Because the Hot Biafra TV is where I will tell you everything that you need to know and of the truth. And some of you that are asking if we are praising Mazenan Kano or if we are protecting, if we are praising Biafra, if we are protecting Mazenan Kano or if we are protecting Biafra, come and listen. That is why you need to share this. When you listen finish, then you'll be able to know if Mazenan Kano is the right man to follow or the Razor Uchemefo. I've given him the name today. Razor Mefo. Anyway, I'm going to write anything about him, I must add Razor to his name, because he says he's a razor that is going to cut. And we have seen how deep he have cut. Thank you so much, my brothers and my sisters. Now, listen and listen good, please, and share this video. Don't listen alone. Invite other people, share it on WhatsApp, share it on Facebook, share it on Messenger, share it on YouTube, share it everywhere. We are going there. Listen and listen good.
Good morning. Are you there?
Good morning. Good morning, Master Peters.
Welcome to the program.
Thank you very, very much for having me. And my special regards to all the Biafrans, especially IPOB members all over the world. My name is Reverend Father Augustine Odinnagwa. Father Odinnagwa is from Uraoku in Idemele, Biafra land. I live here in New Jersey, and I serve the indigenous people of Biafra in the best of my capabilities. Once again, good morning, everyone. Of course, depending on your location around the world, I have been mandated by a committee which I got new to head that was looking into the issue between Mazenamdi Kano and Uchemefo until last Sunday, when we had a Zoom meeting that put a lot of people off. And so the committee has requested me to let our people know that somebody somewhere was aware that there was a problem between our leader, Mazenamdi Kano, and Uchemefo, and we were doing something until what happened on Sunday happened. First of all, I want to make this clearly known to everyone. Both the committee members, including myself, Madam Bridget Okafor, the leader of the Biafran women in the U.S., and one of us, a doctor from Texas, who is well known to the IPOB members, especially Mazenamdi Kano and Uchemefo, is a very honorable man, very quiet, but very, very gifted in wisdom. three or four senior members of the committee. And we have unreserved respect and love for Mazen Nambekano and Uche Nefo. And we shall ever remain grateful to them for the marvelous work they have done in bringing this Biafra struggle to this point, in spite of all odds. And so it pained us when we learned that there was a problem between them. As a matter of fact, it was Madam Bridget Okafor who, in her wisdom, was asking herself, how come our leader has not broadcast and Uche Nefo is not on the air, has not been on the air for a while? Is there something wrong? Are they sick or something? She decided to find out what was going on. And she called Uche Nefo. She couldn't get through. Probably the number was changed. She remembered that she had her wife's number. So she called his wife's number. So he called his wife and got the wife. The wife told her that the number has changed. He gave her the current phone number for Mazu Jennifer. And she called and got Jennifer on the line. And Uche Nefo started narrating a lot of issues to her. At the point, she was like, Uche Nefo, I hope you don't mind if I bring in Father Dustin Odimegwa and this other doctor. For his own interest, he didn't want me to mention his name. Uche Nefo had no problem with it. Bridget Okafor brought us into the line and called Uche Nefo back and told him, can you repeat what you are telling me? And Uche Nefo narrated a whole lot of things that were going on between him and Mazen Nambekano and the members of POS and other issues. At the point, I told him, Mark, if you don't mind, can you be more specific instead of making general statements? Because we are not here to listen to you. We are here to find out exactly what happened. We want to get to the root of the problem and possibly do our best to resolve the issue between both of you so that we can move on. Because it will be almost incomprehensible for the people following two of you to hear that you are having this type of problem.
Are you listening?
It comes out in the public domain.
Okay.
And he obliged and started itemizing major concerns. And in the end, we had four of them, which I will not mention on the air. Okay. Because of confidentiality, which the committee has insisted upon. But at the end of the day, at the end of the story, we were very, very pathetic. And we commended him for his patience, for remaining consistent in spite of all odds, and committed to the goal of achieving the restoration of Biafra.
Keep listening.
At the same time, we made it clearly known to him that in Igbo adage, Adebioku Nonwofonye,
okay,
that we're going to take back all these complaints to Mazen Nambekano and hear his own side of the story. But we gave him an assurance that every single one of these major four issues he raised will be addressed and satisfactorily handled so that we can move forward, because we have come a long way. He was okay with our meeting with him. He was grateful, In the end, we spent more than 2 hours with him on those issues. But I wouldn't forget that then on a couple of times he mentioned that we have passed this stage. And when I asked him what you mean by that we are past this stage,
are you listening?
He said, well, this thing has been happening for a while.
We're past this stage.
I said, we do respect, we have no idea. We thought everything was you are mature enough. Mama Sumna Mekani is mature enough. We thought you are handling whatever issue that come between you.
Yes.
If not that this Madam Bridget decided to check out on you guys, we will not know. And now that we have known, we are going to put everything possible, every effort possible, to get to the root of it and make sure that every single one of them is addressed to everybody's satisfaction. And so we left. This was on Saturday, the 14th of November. And then we started reaching out to Tony and Mazen Nambekan, of IPOB.
Listen, don't go nowhere.
And eventually succeeded in securing an appointment with him. And we made it clearly known to him.
They got
this is not going to be 10 to 15 minutes appointment, no.
Okay.
We need at least an hour, 30 minutes to 2 hours.
Good.
Because we want us to meticulously address every concern that we can raise.
You needed a listing.
Looking for the cause, for the solution. And our effort is to make sure that we work out a workable relationship between both of you so that you take us to the end of the journey, which is already near. He said, okay, that we should give him time to look at his schedule. And then eventually, he came up with Sunday, the November 22nd, 8 a.m. in the morning.
And they cannot give them dates.
He said he will have sufficient time, that time, to meet with us. This was, we were able to secure this time on Wednesday or Thursday of last week. So when we secured the time, we called Mazu Jennifer back and told him we have secured an appointment with Mazu Nambekan.
Are you listening?
On Sunday, November 22nd at 8 a.m. in the morning, New York time, which will be 2 p.m. Biafran time. And we assured him that as soon as we finish with Mazu Nambekan, we will get back to him. We are going to present his own complaints to him and then find out if he has anything against you. And then we are going to get back to him, to you, to let you know what he said in case you have any counter motion to whatever he said. And then eventually we shall work out a time to meet, to have a joint meeting with both of you on the line with the committee. At that point in time, everybody will be able to say his mind, even if you want to shout or you want to curse one another, you can do it. We'll be patient with you guys that day.
Thank
you. But at the end of the day, we will make sure that the real thing is resolved.
Thank you.
So that we can move forward.
Thank you.
So this was on Wednesday or Thursday. And then on Saturday morning, that was I think on the 24th or so, I woke up on Saturday morning. And then I saw an invitation to a Zoom meeting that was coming from Mazu Jennifer.
Listen, for some of you maybe that just joined the broadcast now, they called Ujemefo to hear from him what is happening, why he haven't been coming online, and why our leader have not been speaking. Ujemefo told them what happened. He turned out all his problem, what Mazu Nambekan is doing to him that he doesn't like. They now consulted Mazu Nambekan. Mazu Nambekan said his own part. They now say, Mazi, we are going to bring you and Uche together to discuss this issue and iron it out. And they agree. Then they told Uche, do not bring this outside. This is the family. For some of those people who are saying, why can't they settle it inside? Why can't they bring it outside? Blah, 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 blah. Okay. Now, these people wanted to solve this problem. This panel want to solve this problem. Mazi Nankan agreed. Uche Mefor agreed. Now, Uche Mefor, listen to what Uche Mefor did. Listen.
An invitation. And as far as an open invitation, I called the person who sent me the invitation.
On Zoom.
He said, yeah, he wants Uche Mefor to be distributing it to everybody.
You hear? To everybody.
I said, okay, thank you very much. I just want to let you know that I got it.
After they have agreed to have this resolution together, discuss it inside, Uche Mefor now created a Zoom meeting, then sharing it, telling people to distribute it to everybody. Listen, and listen good.
So in the second part, I asked myself, what would this Zoom meeting be all about?
I hope
it is not related to the issue he is having with Martin and the camera.
Okay.
Because of that, I said, I don't want to take chances. So I called one of the Uche Mefor's childhood friends who lives in New York, who is also from the same town with him, living close friends. I called him and said, this is the invitation I got from Uche Mefor that is calling a Zoom meeting. He said, yes, he got it. I said, please, let me tell you this. We discovered that Uche Mefor has been having a problem with Mazi Nnamdi Kanu the previous Saturday. And we spent more than 2 hours with Uche Mefor. And he told us everything.
Are you listening?
That he could remember what's going on between them. And we assured him. I told him that as a brother, we are from the same area, these three towns have a lot in common, including marriage. And we are always related as brothers. I assured him, I said, brother,
his own brother.
That I will make sure that we get to the end of all these issues. I said, this is what I want you to do for me. He was happy to hear that we are moving to the issue. Maybe he already knew that there was a problem. So he assured me that this is what you want to do for me. Call Uche Mefor immediately and tell him that Father Augustine sent you to plead with him. If this Zoom meeting was going to relate to the issues he's having with Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, please, please, let him suspend it for now.
Do you hear him?
Since we're already looking into the issue, into the problem.
So, but to us, those that are calling us names, listening, those that are saying, you are not supposed to put mouth, you don't know what is happening between them, one must be defending Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. There are things that we know that you don't know. There are things that is happening that you can't even hear some of us say it until it is right time to say it. And when we come to dish out some information to you, you start calling us name. Listen, they begged Uche Mefor. He called his best friend in New York. Please, call Uche Mefor. Tell him not to. This Zoom meeting you have created, after they have consulted him, spoke with him over 2 hours, consulted Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, spoke with him over 1 hour, 30 minutes, then put meeting together to bring them together to discuss and solve this problem once and for all. Then Uche Mefor went and created a Zoom meeting, sharing it, tell people to continue. Because Honorable Eko, Uche Mefor have received money, Honorable Eko, that he must surely do what he wants to, that damaging that he wants to cause, that he must cause it. That is why he continued. Now listen, from this moment I will be talking. If this man talk, I will analyze, then until it gets to finish.
He said, sure, I will do that. I will do that as soon as I came out of Money Mass. He was going for Money Mass. And when he came out, he called him. And I know he spent quite a length of time with him. When he called me back, because I told him, as soon as you finish, call me back. You know what he said. And he called me back a little bit later. Father, I tried my best. Unfortunately, he refused. He said he was going on with the Zoom conference.
Father called his best friend. His best friend called him and begged him and begged him and begged him. He refused. He said that he will not do that, that he must carry on with the Zoom conference. Thank you.
And he sounded very angry. I said, it's okay. I'm going to call him myself directly. So on a second thought, I said, let the members of the committee know. So I called the members of the committee and let them know what was going on. But the bridges confirmed that he got the Zoom meeting invitation. So we said, we have to call him immediately. So we called Uchenna Fo again and luckily got him on the line. And we spent more than 3 hours trying to persuade him, plead with him, convince him on the need.
Do you hear?
To postpone the Zoom meeting.
Do you hear?
And we specifically made it known to him that millions of people are following him and Mazen and the Kano, not Father Adinagba.
I feel like catching this idiot.
And
I feel like catching all these idiots that you are bouncing, grabbing on the Facebook, saying, I will do this, I will break a leg, I will break. I feel like I can catch them. I will tell them no be seen amount. A man who have condemned himself to death is not afraid of death anymore. A man who has stand out to take bullets for everybody is not afraid of death. Listen and listen good.
And yet they have a responsibility. You cannot guarantee, once you go on this Zoom, open Zoom meeting, there is no guarantee that this is not going to get out in the public domain.
They were begging him to stop.
And if people hear it, that they are having a problem with Mazen Nandekano, they will not be listening to who is right or wrong.
Of course.
They will be so devastated.
Mm-hmm.
Please, find it within your heart to reconsider this meeting and reschedule it. Give us a week or two so that we can come to the end of the process we have already started. We pleaded, Madam Bridget to come, was all over herself, pleading, telling Mazen Nandekano that he was kneeling down and begging him, please, that if this thing gets out, it was going to be a disaster. Uchenna Fo kept saying, I have heard you,
somebody
but remember,
will
nobody will tell me what I will do,
okay.
What I can do.
Okay.
I have overgrown that.
Okay.
Yeah, I have been hearing all that.
He have overgrown that. Before he joined the struggle, he had no paper. Now he have gotten passport. Before he joined the struggle, he had no house. Now he have a house. Before he joined the struggle, he was not even as fat as it is as he is now. But now, what did you go for? Before he joined the struggle, he have not achieved anything in his life. But now he think he have achieved a lot. So he have overgrown listening to people that matters in the struggle. And the Obidobian was pushing him. Don't mind them. Continue. Do go on with your Zoom meeting. Now, continue listening.
For a long time now, that something will be done or something will not be done. We said yes. We quite understood that you have been hurting. But remember, you are not alone. This is freedom fighting. This is not an ordinary organization. Everybody is hurting. What is going on in Nigeria is hurting everybody, even those who are not members of IPOB. And I remember telling him that, let me tell you this, in freedom fighting, the highest sacrifice is for one to give his life. It doesn't matter what effort you are putting, doesn't matter what effort Mazen Nandekano has put in. One person who has put in his life for this struggle, he has sacrificed more than two of you.
You listen?
And what we are telling you is not about you and Mazen Nandekano.
People have
it's
died.
About millions of these people who have sacrificed their lives, probably two of you. And millions of people who will be so devastated if this thing gets out into the public. Therefore, we are giving you advice and suggestions and letting you understand the wider implication of what an effect it might have on people if this thing ever gets out in the public forum. And they cannot guarantee that it will not. He said anywhere that he has heard what we said, and
very wicked as
he will think about it.
Very wicked.
But he kept saying that as far as he is concerned, that we are past this stage.
You hear him?
But on wickedness, I'm saying, now what told her, one of the things you mentioned is that there are people who are abandoning the low people in the hospitals who cannot be taken care of.
Mm-hmm.
You mentioned it, and that caused her personally.
Mm-hmm.
And Madam Bridget told Richard McCall, as we speak now, that she is donating $1,000.
You hear? Do you hear the people that have Biafra at heart? This Madam Bridget is talking about here. He's telling Richard McCall, do not go on with this year's Zoom meeting. I am kneeling down to beg you. There are people that shot at Obibu that are still in the hospital, that she is donating $1,000, right? No. She's donating $1,000. Let us put our head together to sort that problem, to make sure that they get treatment. Richard McCall continues saying, they have overgrown that. Richard McCall is wicked. Richard McCall does not care about Biafrans. Richard McCall does not care about your well-being. Richard McCall does not care about the movement. Richard McCall is only after his pocket, his stomach, and what he's going to benefit. The money that is involved, that is what is involved. That is what he is interested. Just listen.
And as soon as we finish this reconciliation process, this is going to mobilize or the IPO, the Biafran women, they're going to raise a sufficient amount of money to take care of those people, and the money will be handed over to you directly so that you know how to dispense it and make sure that these people get the required attention they needed.
Okay.
Because the issue of Obibo took everybody by surprise.
Yes.
And he had once again she assured him that we were sure that all these issues are addressed with Onyendu and the reconciliation reached. At the point I told Uchimepo, when he kept insisting that, well, he's not sure whether he will postpone it, he has already scheduled it. I told Uchimepo, we are not asking you what to do. At this point in time, we have spent more than 2 hours. We are not asking you what to do or what not to do. We are advising you. We are giving you just half other side of the story, the coin, which you may not know. Please, even if you don't want to postpone this Zoom meeting for the next 1 week or two, why don't you get to the meeting? Let the people know that there is a trusted group that is looking into the issue between you and Mazenal, and for which you intended, well, for which you called the meeting.
Very wicked.
And then you want to give these people the benefit of the doubt and see what they come up with.
You want to go out?
You think someone can find? I will recall the meeting. For now, please, I apologize that I don't have much to say. Why don't you do it?
Hi.
Even if you don't want to postpone the meeting, it's too late. Calling them is too late. I said between Saturday and Sunday is not too late. So this was how we left him. He said, okay, that he was going to think about it. And then the next morning was Sunday. We met with Mazen Nandekano at exactly 8 a.m. New York time.
Pay attention.
And we presented to him a 4 major points that Mazen Jennifer has against him.
From this moment, pay attention.
Against him.
From this moment, pay attention.
And then, one by one, he addressed every one of them.
Yes.
Gave his own side of the story about every one of them.
Okay.
And then in the end, he said, you must have one or two things against him because we want to find a way to wrap up all these things and then move on. He said, yes, he presented 2 major points.
Okay.
2 major issues he has against the general.
Okay.
Then we asked him a couple of questions, which he answered.
Okay.
And then we told him that, before we gave him the final word, he said,
listen, this Uchimefo, they spoke to him on Saturday, begging him to wait. Don't forget that they have fixed a meeting with Mazen Nandekano, Uchimefo refused. which we first started sharing the Zoom meeting link to everybody, that everybody should get it. Now they went back to Mazinan Kano and gave him four major key problems that Uchenna presented to them. And Mazinan Kano explained each and every one of them in details. And also told them that he had also two things against Uchenna that he wants to talk about. That is where he is. So listen.
That he would like us to schedule a joint meeting between him and Uchenna.
Nandi Kano want them to call Uchenna.
And then we can address these issues.
One on one.
Wherever he is found guilty, that he was more than willing to apologize to Uchenna.
Mazin Nandu Kano promised that if they bring him and Uchenna together after the case, if he find guilty, that he will apologize to Uchenna. What a humble leader! Hi, God, why? Why are you putting this burden on this man? It's too much. He promised to apologize to Uchenna if he is at fault in that meeting. If he is at fault, we apologize to Uchenna. He will tell him to forgive him if he's at fault. That they should bring Uchenna together. Two of them will have a meeting. This group of people that want to settle them. If he's at fault, he's going to apologize, he's going to say sorry. I'm weeping down there in my heart right now, hearing Mazinan Kano say his deputy. That is to show you how humble this man is. That is to show you how humble Mazinan Kano is. Because of the manner and the way he's speaking to our people on radio, when they provoke him, you think that Mazinan Kano is the devil, that he doesn't forgive, he doesn't do this. Look at him speaking. That they should bring Uchenna for let them resolve this case. If he found you guilty, he's going to beg. He's going to apologize. Ahe muna wane mjelaga Abirego Ihe mefo melanyi Ahe muna wane mjelaga Mefo puta nuzorem nambi. Hi! Let us continue.
You don't expect him out as a committee to hold Uchenna for responsible and accountable wherever he offended him and demand that he has to apologize.
You see it?
He said, in all honesty, you just read our minds.
You see
and
it?
That was exactly going to be our next step.
That is what Mazinan Kano said.
Sure, that he's born on a fellow.
That he will apologize if he's at fault. Then the committee should also hold Uchenna Mufo responsible. If Uchenna Mufo did anything wrong to him, that Uchenna Mufo should also apologize. So that we can move forward. This is the thing that has happened in the secret. The thing that has happened in the secret. That all of you that are insulting me, calling me names, saying all manner of nonsense against me because I was saying what is truth. Look at the leader that is worthy of being praised. We are praising him. He's a savior. Listen.
To be in that joint before God and man. I'm not trying to please anybody. When it comes to a matter that is so serious, I don't care who you are.
Thank you.
It doesn't matter to me who you are.
Thank you.
Especially considering that millions of people are involved.
Thank you.
We are not doing this. We didn't take up this challenge because of that man. Nandi Kano and Uchenna cannot resolve their problem. No. We took it up because deep down us, we felt that we owe it as a responsibility to the millions of IPOB members and their friends in general to intervene and make sure
share this video
that we get to the root of it.
Please, I beg you, share it.
A lasting peace and
share
progress
please.
So that we get to the end of our journey. See, it wasn't as if we are concerned whether you are the leader or not. No. We were hell-bent on getting to the truth. And we will compel you to give us the truth, to give us answers where if they are necessary. We are prepared for it. And we made it clear enough to them. I am 261 in August last year. What I'm bringing is about 63.
Hi,
Mazinan Kano. They have nothing to lose.
Hi.
We are working for the millions of people who have committed their lives in this problem. who have shed their blood.
Who goes to equity issue clear handed?
So I'm not saying it because of
Mazin Nnamdi. Mazin Nnamdi Kanu went to equity with clean hand. That is why he asked for him and Uche Nwafor to be brought together and discuss the problem. If he is found wanted in any way, that he will apologize to Uche Nwafor. But if Uche Nwafor is found wanted also, that Uche Nwafor should also apologize to him. This is a leader. This is a man that is leading us. This is a man that people were calling bad name, that people were asking for him to be killed. But why did Uche Nwafor refuse? Egocentric syndrome is embedded into Uche Nwafor's bloodstream. Egocentric syndrome. Ego, Mwampako, Anyuku, Okochicho is what I've taken over Uche Nwafor. That is why he went ahead with that Zoom meeting after all these things. Listen, this man, this Father God will bless you. Father Odimewa, Chukwukeme Magagosigi. I will speak to you maybe after this program.
But you know, I am focused on the truth. And that was why I told my little at the point in time. We are not here to hear your story. I am looking for the facts. Unless you want to tell us the story and then we'll say, yeah, no, we are looking for the facts because we are going to look at them. We are going to do something. I am looking for the truth. So when my son said, I will say, well, thank him for his openness and willingness for the meeting.
You see?
And then we got back to him before he made the play. I got him on the phone again. And then we relayed to him the answers that Mazin Nnamdi Kanu gave to his four complaints. He disagreed with God, get everything Mazin Nnamdi Kanu said. He said, no problem.
Okay.
You are free to disagree with his answer.
Do you understand this? People, do you understand this? When you have problem with somebody and people came to settle that problem, and the person you're having problem with say, okay, now come, let us discuss about this one-on-one. Uche Nwafor said no, that he disagreed because only go, you have collected money. Uche Nwafor have eaten something, you have collected money. Uche Nwafor have collected bribe from the Nigerian government that Mazin Nnamdi Kanu have refused for so many years. That is why he said no, he must go on with his Zoom meeting. All of you, shame on you all that we are calling us name, we that were exposing Uche Nwafor. Shame on you all that we are beating your chest, saying that this and that, there must be peace. The peace resolution was made already in the secret. There was peace. This panel came to make peace, which we refused. Which we forced him back. You are listening to Father Odimegwa. He is on Facebook. Go and check him out and ask him if what I'm playing now is his voice, if it is truth or not. But I will continue playing it until it is done. But all of you that have been insulting Mazin Nnamdi Kanu, beating your chest, saying all sorts of nonsense, and insulting myself to those of you that call my name out, that have mentioned my name on your video, you are owing me apology. Or the thunder that will shoot you, that will fire you, when I have said it and I will say it again, that come on, also, we sign it. Kaman Ososo, God of thunder and lightning, will sign it. Then Amadio will seal it. That is my promise to you. You hear what happened in the past? The things that I have noticed, that I have information of that you don't have, and I did not say it. I just keep quiet, waiting for the right time. And this is the right time for you to know. To look your stupidity, to look at yourself and see the stupidity written all over you for calling me names because you don't know what is happening behind. You don't know what is happening on the ground. Now listen.
I'm responsible. And again, Mazin Nnamdi Kanu has these two issues against you. What have you just said? Then you get your own version of the story. Yes, good. Well, I'm good. But now, the next step, the committee has decided to take is that we're going to have a joint meeting with two of you on the ground.
Thank you. Do you see how intelligent people do struggle? Intelligent people. So many intelligent people, so many grounded intelligent people and smart people, which before have complained, Mazin Nnamdi Kanu have complained. Now, the next step is to bring in that are having this issue together. Let us discuss it. Then watch and listen to what happened next.
That we're going to follow up with Mazin Nnamdi Kanu as soon as he's secure, and we're going to get back to you to confirm the death. And that date and time, we are not looking for 1 hour, we are not looking for 2 hours, we are looking at least 3 hours. Because we'll be patient enough. You see, to breakfast with all you guys, because we want to get to the bottom of this.
Yes.
Put some photo as well. I don't know about such a meeting, I don't know about it, and I said, "Man, please."
I don't know about such a meeting.
This is not optional.
Yes.
I'm not even asking you to consider it. It is a must.
Okay.
Because we are at it.
He's running.
And we must get there.
On our watch, so he's running. He doesn't want to speak with Mazen Nandika because Mazen Nandika can't be a go. Why we need to negotiate on that meeting? It's not the thing that we need to bring outside. It is internal, and they have tried to settle it internal, and which before refused. Makanori, oh, you are gone. Hey, listen, he was running away. He's not aware of that meeting, and he's not going to be there. Listen,
this issue.
A lot of people told me about it.
So that we can move forward, please. We're not asking you whether you will consider it or not. It is compulsory. He said, "Okay, I'll tell you." And then before we left, Madam DJ Dokapo came back and said, Uchema, please, I am still kneeling down and pleading with you about this Zoom meeting they're going to have. My mind is telling me that this will not come out well. So please, I am pleading with you. You may say that it is late now to postpone it. Please, when you go there, know how you present your case. Know how you do this. Let the people know that something is already going on. Because we're getting to the, we're definitely going to solve this problem once and for all. She prayed again. And then the other doctor, everybody came in again. I reminded him what could be, the court will be possible disastrous effect of such Zoom meeting. But if he's made up his mind, we cannot change it.
You hear?
We can only suggest for him.
You hear it? They try to stop him from that Zoom meeting. That Zoom meeting is a test. It's going to be like a testimony. No, not testimony. It's going to be like evidence to the people that have paid him that what he want me to do, I have done it. Because if he fails to do that Zoom meeting, he will be in the hot seat with those people that have paid him off. You people are dealing with intelligent people. We are smart. We are intelligent. Which of doesn't want to settle with Mazen Nandikano? Which of doesn't want peace with Mazen Nandikano? Which of wanted to punch the back of IPOB? With that is result that he's having on his hand. Reza Uchemefo knew all the whole truth that if he faced Mazen Nandikano on that committee meeting, that he was Manchita Aja, Uchemefo Manchita Aja, Aja won Naira Manchita, that is why he ran away. They beg and make sure that they resolve this issue back in the backyard. Uchemefo refused. Then these people have nothing to do than to give up for him because he have already circulated all the Zoom meeting to all the people that are aware that he's about to do a damage in the struggle. Listen.
If you need a leader for this thing, I'm not supposed to force you to drink.
Hugo, 8, 1.
I'm being a family man. About 1 hour, gone out, yellow. Because millions of people are following to a field. He said, okay, he has heard what we said. By then, it was about 20 minutes to one.
Okay.
So when we left him, I told the committee, look, I have mass at 2 o'clock, and I have 20 to 25 minute drive to go. So we must suspend it until afterwards we continue from where we stopped. So I rushed into my house, into my business. I didn't know what to do. I have not showered, I have not prepared, and I'm not in my bed to put myself together for the mat. Then I decided to heat up some rice with you, and then eat something. I'm not eating breakfast. When I was eating my breakfast, my meal, I started to rush, take shower, brush up, and take shower, dress up. As soon as I dressed up, collected my food, I sat down. I was not eating my food halfway when I got a call from a priest. I was like, this is a member of our group. We have a group of priests which I formed. We have about 29 of us who are passionate about Biafra. And we are working and praying every day for the restoration of Biafra. Biafra. Many of them are very passionate. And he is one of them. So he called. I wanted to send a message, but I'll call you back I'll call you back. You know, thank him, let me finish my meal and then collect my balls. Once I get into the car, I call him back. Then my mind kept telling me, pick this call. Father, please, pick this call. So I picked the call immediately. I said, Father, what's up? He said, Father, I don't know. Father, what is going on? Father, what is happening to us? Father, I am finished.
By then, before, he's already online on the Zoom, gossiping and doing the job that he was paid for. Listen.
I said, Father, what is that? He said, are you listening to UTM4 on Facebook? I don't know what UTM4 is saying on Facebook. Oh my goodness, oh my God, Father, I can't believe I am losing it now. I said, Father, hold on a second. Because I felt this might be going into some health or psychological problems. So I had to put Madam Bridget Oka for it into the line. I said, Father, this is Madam Bridget Oka, the leader of the Women's Wing, I believe, in U.S. I said, Father, and he continued, Father, please, I am needing, right now, I don't even know what I'm doing. I can't even stand. I am falling. Father, Bridget, be there with him. I said, Father, please, take it easy, relax. Joseph. He said, sit down, get a glass of water. He said, no, this is too much. Father, I can't take this. Why did I turn on this thing now? Why did I turn on? This is hype, but I don't know whether I can survive this. This is too much on me. We kept asking, counseling him, because we thought he was going to get her back. I mean, I was really afraid. I kept coming, I said, Father, you don't matter. This is the work of the devil, and we're going to overcome it in the mighty name of Jesus. It doesn't matter how the devil wants to destroy this problem. It's not going to work. Because our people have sacrificed so much. Our Biafrans have sacrificed too much. And I'm sure that God, he said, Father, why don't you pray for me? I think I've losing it. I said, okay. I started prayer, spontaneous prayers. I said, God, there's never a time in the history of humanity where the power of the devil overcame their own power. It has never happened. The Israelites, when they were in Egypt, they never knew that they would never get out of Egypt. But when you delivered them, it was like a threat to them, Father, we are the same Israelites who have gone through a lot in Nigeria in the hands of so many monsters who want to consume us. And at this point, we know that this is their time. Your time is the best. And we have brought out your servant, Mazi Mandekanu, to lead us out of
this. Share this program. Share it, please. Share.
No amount of effort from the devil to stop it. Doesn't matter
everywhere.
How it is coming.
Everywhere.
This is not going to be different.
Share it.
I prayed for almost 10 minutes because I took time to make sure that that Father calmed down. And in the end, I said, we must overcome in the mighty name of Jesus. We answered amen. I said, we must overcome in the mighty name of Jesus. He said amen. He said, Father, thank you. Thank you. I don't even know what I'm going to do now. Father, take a glass of water. Relax. Take off your rosary, take off your breath, take off your, if you have chapel around you, go to the chapel and tell, if you want to cry to Jesus, tell him why now, and what is happening. Do it, and you get back yourself, because I know that it is, it was the first time I was hearing that the Zoom meeting was happening. And before we finished, I had about three calls. One of them from one of my cousins, who is a nun in Texas. It let me get my reserve ready immediately for mass because it was already running late. I already called and told them that I was running late. And then as soon as I entered my car, I called my cousin back because I know that she has been so passionate about everything about her is different. With her spirit, that she has converted all the nuns in their community into Biafra. They never wanted to hear about Biafra until she came. And she systematically converted all of them. And when I picked up her call, she was crying. I said, sister, take it easy. What you said? He said, Father, I don't know what has come over our people. Is this how we're going to finish? How we're going to be finished as a people? That this is, I say, sister, there is nothing that is new under the sun. Nothing cannot be overcome by the power of God.
Of course.
He said, Father, I know that this is too much. I said, she said, if you picked my call a few minutes ago, when I called you the first time, all the sisters were lying down in the living room crying. And nobody could console the other because of the Zoom meeting. I said, yeah, no, I know it is serious. But you know what? We shall overcome. And I told her, please, I've got to where I was going. I'm already late. I'll get back to you after mass. That was how I went for the mass. And by the time I finished mass, I had 11 calls, three of them from the Reverend Father. Some had called more than four times during the mass because I put my phone in silence. Now, why have I taken time to say all this? I've taken time to say all this because the next couple of days, it was all counseling, doing counseling front and back to get people, to help people get back their spirit. And I kept wondering within myself, what happened? How come that we took all these hours? We spent all of these hours with you, Jennifer. He knows me that too well. I have special love for him. I have special love for Mazen Ambedkar. We have met on a couple of occasions in serious meetings about the progress of this movement. And I have respected his spirit of dynamism and his depth of thought. How come that we spent all these hours and we're not able to convince you, Jennifer, to postpone this meeting? In all honesty, till tomorrow, I still have not been able to fathom it. Why? Because we cannot solve any problem on the social media. It doesn't matter how correct or how right you are. You can't solve any problem in the social media. Marriages are not solved in the social media. They are not solved in the courts. It is reliable people who come between you. Issues will be coming between two people, three people, wherever two or three are gathered. There will always be issues. The good solution is always coming from the inside. Because now the modern man in your own way, the best in the model. I couldn't fathom it until tomorrow. And the committee was struggling with the same thoughts. And that was why when we met the next time, he said, you know what? Let us suspend whatever we are doing for now. And then monitor what is going on. At the end of the day, I have this message to put across to all the members of IPOB on behalf of the committee. Because during the short time we went into this case, we made a lot of investigations. We have not done any. Personally, I have not done much within that week. I didn't even do much since that week, actually. Because we are trying to figure out the difference in the people. Why is it, after all this effort, we cannot forget the head to do it? Is it because he has been so hard, or what?
He was collected money, because he collected money.
So at the end, we said we are going to suspend our activities for now. We are still open in case of there is any opportunity to continue in future. But we want to put these few words to our people, especially the principal officers in IPOB. Doesn't matter your position. Neither you as a principal officer give out any order or instructions on the name of the leadership of Mazu Nnamdi-Kanu without the prior knowledge and approval of Mazu Nnamdi-Kanu. Do not go to tell any group or anybody that Mazu Nnamdi-Kanu sent you to discover a lot of lapses in the communication between the two and possibly caught by people who are in between. It is never done. If you have any issue that you want people to pay attention, make it known to them while you are giving them the instruction. Don't use the name of Mazu Nnamdi-Kanu. If you have not if you are not giving him prior information and gotten the approval from him, don't take laws into your hands. I'm saying it for all the principal officers all over the world. Because mistakes can be made, and before you remedy it, it has become a disaster. And eventually we discover that the two people involved are ignorant of most of what was going on. Because we know that Mazu Nnamdi-Kanu has a lot on his head. He's dealing with a lot. If you cannot get him, don't give out that order, don't give out that instruction. Wait until you get him, no matter how emergent order. And even if you give it on his name, let him know later that you did give out this instruction on his name. Now this is why you did it, because it was emergency. So that you know how to handle it. He's a human being, he's not a god. Because you may think you are doing the organization or the struggle a favor by using his name. Meanwhile, you are sowing a seed that may end up rocking the boat, that it will never happen, because IPOB is ordained. This mission is ordained beyond all reasonable doubt. And every religion in Nigeria is now realizing that what IPOB and their friends are doing is the right thing. And everybody is thinking about the referendum today, thanks to the effort of this movement. Therefore, if you are a principal officer in IPOB, never you take your responsibility lightly. And make sure you use it judiciously. Judiciously, I repeat. And to the rest of IPOB members, especially their friends, IPOB members in particular, but their friends in general, the committee will want to let us know that what we are doing is freedom fighting. We are not in a strip club discussing Biafra. There's no room for democracy because we are not discussing Biafra.
Are you listening?
What is guiding us is command and control.
Yes.
Obey before complain.
Thank you so much, my father. Thank you.
The IPOB and this freedom fighting is all about sacrifice. It's not about benefit or about ego or about or about your people. No. Because what is at stake is too much. If we fail, everybody is going down, whether we like it or not.
Whether we like it or not, everybody, if we fail.
We have a living example in our brothers, the Israelites.
Yes.
When they were destroyed, how many hundreds and thousands of years? They never woke up. Even those in diaspora, they started killing them in millions. Mm-hmm. 6 million were killed in diaspora.
Okay.
So even if you think you are comfortable in diaspora, okay, be careful, because no good harm or good. If we fail as a people in this freedom fighting, you may think you are trying to pay Mazu Nnamdi-Kanu back, or pay Uchenna back, or pay this man back. That you might be endangering the lives of a whole generation. As we speak, the Fulanis are all over Biafra land. We saw them brought in drones, and the lot of ammunition brought in today. Nobody has told us that any single one of those people has been sent back to the north. They are still there. So they are going to fight us and destroy us from inside.
If we don't get our self together and fight this demon, not just one demon, one spark facing us, we are going down as a people. It doesn't matter where you are in diaspora. You'll be poor. It will only take a matter of time. 20, 30, 50 years, we'll be gone as a people. And many, many nations have gone in this group.
Now listen, I want to chip in something here. As you heard, why we continue to listen, because the he's about to round up. But before he round up, let me chip in something. Let me refresh the memory of those of you who are listening to Radio Biafra 247. You guys know that Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is always lashing on Nigeria government, exposing the man in Aso Rock, which is against it. Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is continually lashing, exposing the man in Aso Rock, telling the world what is happening in Aso Rock. When Nigeria government have meeting in Aso Rock, before they finish, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu will air it and tell the whole world this is what they are planning. And because of that, they are retreating. They have not been able to come in full force to begin to unleash their mayhem against our people in Biafra land. It's because of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, not because of Uchimefo. But Uchimefo is against it. Uchimefo refused to broadcast with Mazi Nnamdi Kanu for a very long time because he said that Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is calling the person in Aso Rock, Jibril, that you should forget about the person in Aso Rock. Let us be talking about Biafra. Mazi Nnamdi Kanu told him to go and sit down, that he will not stop, that he will continue. Now, Uchimefo is the only admin that has password to Radio Biafra London application. The application that people listen to worldwide, Uchimefo is the only man that has the password. If I am lying about this, why did Uchimefo use his mouth to say that Mazi Nnamdi Kanu ask him to give him the password? That is to tell you that Mazi Nnamdi Kanu doesn't even have the password of Radio Biafra app. Hello? Those that are calling us gossipers, those that are calling us troublemakers, that we are putting fire. Did you not hear Uche say that Mazi Nnamdi Kanu ask him to give him password? If Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, if there's another person that has password of that Radio Biafra application, I'm asking you, will Mazi Nnamdi Kanu not go to collect it from that person, if not only Uche Mefo? Mefo is the only admin that has password to Radio Biafra London app. Have you now asked yourself, why is it that when Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is talking, hitting Nigeria so seriously, talking about what is happening in Aso Rock, then the app will be saying something. You'll be singing another song that is loaded on it. Who is involved? Mazi Nnamdi Kanu was telling Biafra's long time that Mefo had been bought over without mentioning Mefo name. Intelligently, people didn't get it when he said that the zoo have taken over our radio station. Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is a man of wisdom. I've worked with him closely and I have learned a lot from him. Mazi Nnamdi Kanu speaks in radio. Mazi Nnamdi Kanu used one word to treat 200 words and solve the problem at once. He is very, 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 very meticulous on the choice of his word. When he said that the zoo have bought over our radio, that is why he went and opened radio IPOB community radio, knowing fully well that the Radio Biafra is in charge of the zoo, because they don't want people to hear what Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is saying on that platform. And who is in charge of that radio? It is Uchimefo. Is it clear to you now? Hello, is it clear to you now? Then, Uchimefo is angry that they now open another app that he doesn't have password to, that he doesn't have access to. And that is why he is crying that he has been sidelined. Then the one that you have password to is playing a different record. When our leader is live, it will be saying something else. Why our leader is saying something else? So have you people understand it? How it works? That they bought Uchimefo over. that we they have brought Uche before over. And Mazenankan was giving us the hint that our radio had been taken over by the Zoo government. How do you want to how do you want him to say it? For him to come and say, hey, Uche Mefo, they have paid you. No, he wouldn't speak like that. He wouldn't speak like that. He will speak in a language that all of you will understand, and some of you did not get it. Now, why is it that when he collected the password and changed the password, that radio begin to say everything he was saying? That is to tell you that the admin who is in charge of the radio had been paid, had been caught over. Why Mazenankan is saying something different than the app is saying something different? That pushed Mazenankan to open another application where our people are listening to the radio. I hope you understand this. Thank you so much for your understanding. All of you that are following up this program to the letter, we understand every. I want you to go and listen to this program again and again and again and do your own analysis and see that those people who are castigating me, castigating Mazenankan, say, oh, we are talking about Mazenankan before, you are now burying your face in shame. And we are going to listen to Mazenankan, remember, to the last. So let's continue.
And so every single member of IPOB, you must go home and examine yourself and ask yourself, am I in this IPOB to fight for the millions of people who have died in the 67th and thousands who have died since the end of genocide in the 60s and 70s, and who are still dying today? Am I in IPOB to represent their interest? Or to represent my own personal interest? Please, if you are in IPOB to represent your interest or to buy for position, get out today.
Good word.
So that you know those who are committed to this problem, because what is at stake is too much. Europe wants to wipe us out, if you don't know. Africa. People have said it, a person of a renowned personality, Bill Gates, has said it, in order to save Europe, we must depopulate Africa. And I keep asking this question, because sometimes we don't know the gravity of what we are eating. More slaves were sent to Europe than those who were sent to America. Today, when they got their freedom, we can go to the islands and see where the Americans dumped their own slaves when they gave them freedom. And we have never asked ourselves, what about those who were sent to Europe? Where are they? Where did they dump them? If we don't know the magnitude of what is coming to us as a people, if we are wiped out in 10 days, it doesn't make a difference in Europe and the West. Doesn't matter where you are. And we must understand this, that there is a calculated effort. It's not the same people. And divided, we will fall. And so, it's not a matter of this guy is from my area. It's not a matter of this guy is my friend. Or it's not a matter of this guy is so. No. It's a matter of collective responsibility for both those who have died fighting for this. There is a reason why people are fighting for the freedom of Biafra. And we believe that we have shed so much blood that God has said, enough is enough. This God's time is the best. We are in the right time. And we must pull ourselves together. Forget about all these minor things that don't even add up. And come up with one spirit. Because humanity will stand. It doesn't matter whether you believe in Mazenankan. It doesn't matter whether you believe in IPOB. Pierre Lumumba, one of the renowned social justice advocates in Africa, has told us, the world, listening to Mazen Namdekan, he told Africans, listen to Namdekan. He said, listen to Mazen Namdekan. Many of us know him. He's an intellectual. He's a well knowledgeable man. He understands Africa very well. But he told Africa, listen to Mazen Namdekan. He mentioned his name. And oftentimes,
they don't value it.
We don't value what we have.
We don't. But I do.
And for those of us who have been trying, keep up the spirit. Keep up with the spirit. Because from all indication, this is God's time to set us free. And we are going to put in everything possible together to get it. Because this is not about political freedom. It's not about geographical location, freedom of a geographical location. It is about survival as a people.
Of a people.
It is about survival as a people.
Yes.
Because there are too many enemies.
A lot.
Working hard, sleepless nights. Working sleepless nights to swallow our talk. And we cannot afford to. We must keep up the spirit wherever we are. Do your best to make sure that we continue to move on. Because grace works on nature. God may will to save us, but if God will need our cooperation, it doesn't happen anyhow. It doesn't happen by magic.
Of course.
With God, we need the grace of God. We need our cooperation to achieve this liberation.
That's correct.
And this freedom we are looking for. And so for those of us who are committed, keep up the spirit. Keep up the spirit. Because in the end, victory shall be ours.
You see?
Once again, thank you very much for your time.
You see? Thank you very much, my people, Great Biafrans. Having listened to Reverend Father Odimegwa. Oh my goodness me. I know that a lot of you that watch this program from beginning to this moment now are shivering. I know some of you are crying. I know also all those of idiots, set of idiots that we are beating their chest, jumping up and down, lamenting and saying nonsense. You are far. You are not close. You are not closer to the leadership. You don't know what is happening. By now, they will be covering their face in shame. They will be crying, oh, is this what happened? That Mazen Namdekan was ready to discuss with Uchemefo and these people that came together to discuss this issue. Whatever he is doing to Uchemefo that is not good, he will say. Whatever Uchemefo that is doing to him, Uchemefo will say. Then at the end of the day, if he is at fault, he will beg Uchemefo, Biko Uchebagalo, then they continue. Then if Uchemefo is at fault, Uchemefo will ask him, Biko Mazen Namdekano, Bagalo, Yendu Bagalo, then they continue. But Uchemefo said no. Can you tell yourself the reason why Uchemefo said no? Can you tell yourself the reason why Uchemefo refused to listen to all the great people that have come together, including Reverend Father, that is pastoring a church that Uchemefo believed in the faith to the last? A Reverend Father, not as ordinary pastor. Uchemefo is a Roman Catholic. And he loved Roman Catholic more than his life, even more than this struggle. Uchemefo loved Roman Catholic more than this struggle. And that is his opinion, that is the decision. And a father that is an ordained priest in that same Roman Catholic called you. A lot of people come together, including Reverend Sisters. They have contacted all the Reverend Sisters in so many places into the struggle. They were fighting and praying that God should give us Biafra. All these people, they came together to plead with Uchemefo. Come, let us talk about what is happening between Mazi. Mazi agreed. Namdekano agreed. Namdekano opened the door. So, okay, no problem. Let's talk about it. If I'm at fault, I will beg. If he's at fault, let him beg me too. Uchemefo ran away. Gloria Bombo. Muna wen nem jeraga Abiriego Iheme for Melani Ae Muna Wanem de la Mefo Putanus Orenamdi. Hey, Alili Alibunum, some of Biafra. Ariasoma. I want all of you that watch and listen to this program this morning to begin to reason as human beings. Having listened to this man, you can play it again, you can listen to it again, and you can share it widely. To know at this point in time, you have not, Mazi have not said anything. But the man in between Uche and Mazi, he spoke to Uche, he spoke to Mazi, and he want to bring them together and let us move forward. I've just spoken to you guys now, and you heard him, and Uche refused and went on with his Zoom meeting. Because he said it's a result that is going to court. He have court. We have seen the all the court he have done. On this note, I want to take few calls. This is 1:42 a.m. Sorry, this is 1:42 minutes, and that is 11:24 a.m. I will take some calls. Once it is on 2 hours dot, I think I will bring the program to an end. So any one of you that want to call, please make your call now. Call now, ask your call. It is time to listen from Biafrans. At least few calls. Once it is 2 hours on dot, I will stop. But when you call, tell us, please, I see the heart. Now so I go talk him. Or now so I want talk him. Because I see the heart means truth. And truth is what I've been preaching on this platform. And that truth will set me free and set all of us free. And this Reverend Father Odimegwa, have just said another big truth now. Reveal a very big secret that some of you were not privileged to hear. Let me answer this call. Hello, welcome to the program, I see the heart, Biafra TV. Lower the volume of whatever gadget you are watching with, please.
Hello,
good morning, welcome to the program.
I see the heart, Master, I want to come.
Please tell us your name and talk it, I see the heart.
I see the heart, Master, I want to come.
Thank you, tell us your name and they say it, I see the heart.
Okay, you can hear me now?
Yes, very clear.
You can hear me?
Yes, very, the word is hearing you.
I see the word, so I won't talk out.
Okay, so my brother, tell us your name.
Yeah, my name is Emeka, I'm calling from Malaysia. Yes, my name is Emeka, I'm calling from Malaysia.
Okay, go ahead and tell us, I see the heart. Go ahead, Emeka, we are listening.
I commend you for your programs. Okay. Now, what the issue of Uche Mefo, I want to say something here because Uche Mefo is just like Aaron to Moses, and God knows that Biafra is here already. So without Uche Mefo came out at this time around, so Nnamdi and Biafra at large will not know the enemy of Biafra. So even though we marched to the promised land, so they were there like Kankawa eating us, why would that know? So I believe that God knows the reason why Uche Mefo came out at this time, because the fighting of 1967 is there also. And secondly, as Uche Mefo came out now, it is God that brought him out, so that from then God will expose all his followers, that Biafrans we thought that it is the right people that will follow Nnamdi Kanu. So I want to advise all the Biafrans, nobody to lose hope. Nobody to maybe think the struggle is over. No, struggle is not over. But God is doing something here, which I believe in the nearest future, God will make his way and will march to the promised land. So thank you for answering my call. This is my first time calling you.
Thank you.
May bless.
Thank you so much.
And I believe and I pray that Biafra will come as soon as possible.
Thank you
so much. So all the enemy of Biafra, through Uche Mefo, through TMFO, God will expose them above. Because as many as believe and follow TMFO on Facebook, we have seen them. I know they are the enemy of Biafra. And anyone that attacks your program, we see him or her as enemy of Biafra. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Have you shared this program?
Yes, I shared it. I like it. And even the one you did in the morning, I've shared it already.
Thank you very much. God bless you. This is the kind of calls I want to answer this morning. Thank you. This is the time of call I want to answer this morning. I don't want those that will call and they will talk. Only 3 minutes is enough for you to make your point. Only 3 minutes. This man spent 2 minutes plus. That is close to 3 minutes. Go when you come, you salute us in our usual way, then you go ahead and make your contribution only for 3 minutes. Please. If you speak more than 3 minutes, I will cut you off. I am not going to debate with you. It is not time to debate. I just want to hear your own opinion as a Biafran. That is why I am opening the line to answer you. Good morning. Welcome to the program.
Asidehot, that's why I want to talk now.
Go ahead and tell us your name, please. Asidehot.
Oh, that one talk. No.
Tell us your name, Asidehot.
Tell us your name, Asidehot. Yes, Asidehot. My name is Shema Saint. I'm calling from Nigeria, Lagos.
Go ahead and make a contribution. Only 2 minutes.
Yes, I know. Reverend Father have already said it all. We have been thinking all this while. I have been thinking what happened. I've been worried. But I now hear everything from the Reverend. And the Reverend is telling us now that you have to, all I have from Reverend, I have to separate the staff from the normal thing. So he has said it all. So there's no point arguing. And there's no point in making Uche a headline again. We have to forge ahead. We need to forge ahead. We don't need to be making Uche. We cannot be making Uche a headline again. And you already know that even the same time of Judas, one of you will sell me. And even Judas will not even know. But at the end, the thing falls in his hand. At the end of it now, he say, whoever it is, arrest him. Even Peter had his own time. He denied Christ. Say, love thou me? Say, I will love you to the end. But at the end, he denied him. That shows how it is. But I believe that Reverend have already cleared the whole world what happened and what transpired right from the beginning. So we heard him assist him, and we thank him very, very much for doing it. As we forge ahead, God will help us. God will help Nandi Carlo. God will help everyone involved in making sure this agitation come to reality, or this Biafra come to reality, or this our freedom come to reality. I'm just giving him the Reverend Kudo for all he tried a lot. Up until something number of them, they tried all they can to make sure that a peace reign between Nnamdi Kanu and the deputy. And the deputy is deputy. That's not how. Even Osibanjo here in the country, here, he doesn't have anything to say. All he knew that, go to sleep, go and shaman, go do this, and we do it. That is all. He don't have much mouth. We have not much mouth in the government of the Federation. So we don't have to be sorry and disturbing ourselves on Uche. Uche has chosen his path. Mata has chosen his path. So Uche has given his path. Let's allow him go. It's only the people that will follow him will be able to know who
round up, is who. Round up. I don't want to cut you off. Round up.
The people that will follow him will be able to know
round
who
up.
Is who now. So we have to separate. And the separate is now or ever or never. Take we have you. To separate them now because anyone that follows him, we know that, yes, they are the allies. They are his allies. We'll be able to know them. But IPOP, Biafra is more than a single person.
Thank you.
It's more than Nnamdi Kanu.
Enough.
It's more than even
it's okay.
He must be a leader in everything. And this leader is Nnamdi Kanu. And he has sacrificed everything. He has sacrificed his mother. He has sacrificed his father. He has sacrificed even the prison. He's even agitating for people, even in Northern Access, that is in the prison, that has not been released, that has not been going to any court. He even sacrificed right there in the court, challenging the federal government of Nigeria, the president, challenging the president that president cannot even tell him.
But okay. It's okay. Round up. I want to answer many calls. It's okay. Please, you are taking more than your time.
It brings me a lot. Let's go ahead. Thank you. That's what I have to say now.
Thank you very much. I know you are angry. Yeah, if I give you more time, you're going to speak up to 1 hour. Please, if you call, I don't want to cut you off when you are still talking. I don't want to be rude this morning. What I'm doing this morning is justice to make sure that all of you that we are calling Mazen and calling them and calling us name, we that have been saying all these things and they are calling us, I want you to look at your stupidity. I want you to watch it looking at you. Welcome, Asidehot. Your name and where you're calling from, please.
Asidehot, my brother. Good morning.
Good morning. I see the hot. No, be so you go talk.
Now, sir, I see the hot. Now, sir, you talk. My children are calling from that. Don't be angry with me. I just want to ask you two questions, and that's our third drop before.
Go ahead.
Thank you very much. The first question is, what makes you an IPOB member? You cannot pay your dues. Because as long as the constitution is said, everybody should pay their dues. And you are my deputy. And tomorrow you ask me to bring my receipt. And you cannot provide your own receipt. We are now, people want to get asylum in the UK.
Are you asking me? You ask
yes, now. I'm asking those questions.
It's not a question anymore. You are explaining the question yourself.
Okay, go ahead. One of the problems which raised in that meeting they hold with our reverend is that the people are being injured and they have raised the question they have not attended. The office of Uche as a deputy, what's stopping him coming on the air? As he does now, he claimed that they collected the password from him, they stopped him from broadcasting. He resigned, he has not resigned. Who stopped him now from broadcasting? He's using the same platform, which is the Facebook that he's used to broadcast, his Facebook page. What stopped Uche from setting up people to come up on air to talk to Biafra? We individuals have sent money to individuals that we knew directly they have sentence for this, one way or the other, and he himself knows it. What's stopping Uche, even bypassing Onyedu, to come out to say, we have challenges at hand. Why don't you people contribute money to, without it, making it as if that everything must come out from Onyedu? I have heard Onyedu several times, whatever you can do to see the struggle, do it. What's stopping Uche from setting up a committee himself as a deputy and say, I have a problem in Onyedu or anywhere in Onyedu, whatever, I need people to do this. Next thing for Onyedu will come and say, no, don't do that. Then he has a case. But if you keep quiet, go to DOS, which he knew that this DOS, according to him, he has some issue with one or two people there, and they might not take your case serious. And we that is outside don't know what is happening there. You are now taking a problem on that DOS, bringing it to us.
Random.
Does it make sense?
Random,
I'll
please.
Drop here, sir.
Ran, thank you very much.
Okay.
You did not ask question. You dropped your opinion, and I like it. And I am trying as much as I can to answer as many calls as I can. That is why I don't want people to speak more than 3 minutes. Please, go straight, make your point, then drop. Go straight, make a point, and you drop. If you have a question, maybe you ask your question, then you drop, then I will respond to your question. I have so many calls that are coming in. You people have seen that our leader was ready to amend, to make peace, and discuss with Uche, but Uche said no. Good morning. Welcome to the
hello.
Welcome to the program.
Yeah, I see the host. That's why I want to tell him Uche Moko.
Go ahead and tell the world. And your name?
My name is Wamama Adie Funamba. I'm calling you here from Philippines.
Go ahead.
My Igbo name is Ifeanyi Chukwu.
Ifeanyi Chukwu Nwachineke.
No, my brother, to be frank with you and to be brief, starting from the fourth day I heard from Uche Moko, I never listened to him again whether he's broadcasting. For me not to attack Uche Moko since then is because of the love I have for IPA, the Biafra, and the Mazinam, the Kano. Uche Moko have already collected money from the Zoo government. It's obvious. You understand? We all, let us not pretend as if we are, hey, Uche Moko do this, they passport, the square passport, that time. Uche Moko is not there to fight for Biafra. He doesn't have intention of Biafra at heart. You understand? So let me tell Uche Moko, I'm just sending this message direct to him. Uche Moko should know that we made him who he is today. And we can only bring him down. And for us to bring him down, we can only destroy him from his own home, his village. You understand? So, my brother, I don't want to take much time. Our leader should continue. I urge all Biafran to disregard Uche Moko. He's nobody in this struggle. One IPOB Biafra is bigger than one person. Thank you and God bless you. Continue. Chukwu Kabia will be your strength. Thank you, my brother.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, my brother. I love those people who speak straight, who hit the points. I don't want those who come and talk, 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 talk. there are many people that want to say one or two things in different ways. So I want to take as many as their calls. And there's somebody that have been calling me. The last call you made was, okay, you are calling back. Let me answer your call. Please lower the
volume. Hello, my brother, how are you?
Lower the volume of the gadget you are calling me.
Hello, my brother, how are you?
Lower the, go away from the gadget you are talking to me. I'm hearing myself. I don't want
can
to hear
you
myself.
Hear me now?
I want you to off the gadget you are talking to me with. This thing.
Can you hear me now?
Relax. Yes, I can hear you. I can
hear you. Can you hear me now?
Yes. The word can hear
thank
you.
Thank you, my brother. After the hop, God bless you. God bless you. I'm calling you from South Africa.
Asidehot, tell us your name, Asidehot.
Asidehot, I'm calling you from South Africa. Where I teach school. I'm from Imo State, but I retired to South Africa. I watch your program and I love what you are doing, and I want to appreciate you for what you are doing. May the Lord God Almighty continue to strengthen you. I just have two things to contribute on this your broadcast. One is a question that I want to ask. The other one is the advice that I want to give to you and our leader Mark and the Carlos. This is my first time of following your program. One, my question goes on your on this. I understand that the IPOP has a covenant which everyone takes as a oath before joining the struggle. And my question is that what happened to anyone that break that oath? Because which before as it is now show that he has made his oath or he has betrayed the struggle and the leader as well. So what happened to him apart from people calling him names, what happened to him based on the oath which he took? Now my advice to the struggle and to our leader Marvin Mandekar is this, that he should continue to remain focused because he has been a man of focus. When you read the book of Exodus, you will understand what happened between the Moses and the brother Aaron. Bible said that Moses went to the mountain to collect from the law the commandment, and on his way coming back, he found out that Aaron already divided the house. Already, shifted the mind of the people because the pressure was too much on his side. So I believe maybe the Jew government, the pressure they are putting on Butcher's side, has made him to divide, to delay. So we must not focus on that. We must focus on the goal which God has given to you, our leader. So please, I want to appreciate that every one of us who still believe in this struggle and our leader, Martin Landekalo, should concentrate on the goal, should concentrate on
Rando.
The promised land. Let's not focus on what we pray because he will fail.
Round up, thank you.
If the Zulu is responsible to my to Uchemofo behavior, I can assure you I'm a servant of God. I am praying for this struggle and for our leader. One thing I want to assure you that he will fail.
You see,
as others fail, he will fail. But please, let's concentrate on that struggle and please let us know what happened to people who break the
house. Thank you. As the hearts, now so they talk. My name remembers of Elizabeth. Once again, this platform is hallowed platform, and this is a platform where truth reigns supreme. This is a platform where we say it as the heart, because as the heart is nothing but the truth. And however, the question you ask about the oath, when you are taking oath, and they are calling in the name of Chukwuka Kabiama. Chukwuka Kabiama is the one who is going to take care of any oath breaker. Those that took oath. And they do what they didn't do what they sworn to do. So I pray that all of you that have taken this oath and you are going the way of future before should look back before
Kabbalah is coming. Oh, my father, fucker.
As in the heart, waiting be your name. Good morning, sir.
Okay, Chima from IT Italy.
Go ahead, Mazi Chima, and make your contribution.
Okay. Yeah, I don't want to waste your time. You see, no history, no event. What I want to say is this. Let us address ourselves sometimes, you know, because that Uchenna for this work. May God have a purpose. Something doesn't happen like that. There is a reason. So now, sometimes you may embark on journey at the end of the day. You not end up those people that you start with.
That is correct.
If you can resign, I don't see anything big here. How other men? That is the reason why Mr. Mazi said that we need 100 men, but people don't understand him. So that's my own contribution. We should go on. Let's not forget about it in the town, whatever.
Thank you very much.
Not only mine, the land. Thank you.
Thank you very much, my brother. God bless you. I see the hot. I saw the talkam. And this morning is very, very hot. This platform is very, very hot. I intended to stop this program on 2 hours, but as you can see, it's already on 2 hours. But the gods of the land say, Mazi, give your people more time to air their opinion. And that is exactly what I'm going to do right now. I'm going to wait to get to receive some few calls again before I bring the program to an end. However, we are still on the move. And the brother, I want you to know one thing. The last caller, I'm about to respond to you. Uchenna Mefor is a hindrance to the struggle. Yes, that is why God removed him. It is God that removes Uchenna Mefor. It's not we, because he resigned on his own. Please, as the caller on WhatsApp, I want you to hold on where you are. Hold on where you are. Because I have answered their call. Hold on where you are. So it is Uchenna Mefor who resigned by himself. Uchenna Mefor wrote his resignation letter 6 months ago and tendered to Mazi Nnamdi-Kanu. Mazi Nnamdi-Kanu refused to acknowledge it. He did it again. He refused 3 times. He don't want to respond. Mazi Nnamdi-Kanu wanted peace. Mazi Nnamdi-Kanu wanted peace. He wanted peace. That is why this Reverend Father set up this committee to make peace with them. Mazi Nnamdi-Kanu said, okay, bring Uchenna Mefor. Then I will come. Let us talk about this. If I offend him, I will ask apology. If you offend him, you should ask apology. Let us move forward. Uchenna Mefor said no. For that, for him to say no and go ahead with what he did, that is to show you that he has been what? He has been bought over. So welcome to the program, as it is hot. My sister, your name and where you're calling from.
Yes, as it is hot. Now so with the
talk. Go ahead,
good morning,
my dear sister.
Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are. Yes, after the talk, we are told with the talk. My name is Miriam Nakabiasa. I live in Palace. So, this morning, we are going to say it as it is. We are not going to hide much. We are not going to be afraid of anybody who can call and say. We are not.
Your voice is far from your phone. Your voice is far from your phone. Come closer to your phone so that we can hear you. Your voice is low. Be audible.
Okay. I'm talking here. That video has shown us to do Uchenna Mefor. Uchenna Mefor don't want to. Uchenna Mefor didn't see that he is going. Uchenna Mefor didn't remember the obey and the command. Uchenna Mefor didn't remember the truth. That video, this, our Reverend Father's video, has shown us exactly what happened. You see, so we are right about talking about this Uchenna Mefor thing. We are not small children that are crying. So people should be listening very well. Uchenna Mefor is not our baby. And he can never be the same. He has worked with all the answers. So Uchenna Mefor, you can go to hell and talk whatever you want. But go and leave your comment. Leave your comment on Saturday program today. Uchenna Mefor, you are not the same. We deserve that, you are not to us. Because you are paying our money, you are contributing, you are the one eating the money. Instead of them to use the money to take care of our people at home, they are paying Uchenna Mefor a very heavy treatment. Uchenna Mefor thinks that he is supposed. So Uchenna Mefor is out. Let us continue our struggle. We the right for that and know that Uchenna Mefor is the problem. Uchenna Mefor is the problem. Our leader can never be the problem of struggle. Never. So Uchenna Mefor should go to hell and burn to anything we don't care. That is all I have to say this morning. I'm just angry with Uchenna Mefor. We are paying Uchenna Mefor money for his freedom, for his generation's freedom. And his wife is there. If he honors the people of the system. Eh?
Thank you.
Uchenna Mefor is that he is the goal.
Thank you that so much. Okay. Thank you so much, my sister. Thank you for your contribution. Thank you. As it is hot, now so they talk on the line. It's very, very hot. A lot of people truly want to speak, and I'm going to answer as many calls as possible. Welcome to the program, As it is hot.
Hello.
Welcome to the program, I see the hug.
Hello.
Can't you hear me? I said, welcome to the program, I see the hug.
Hello, hello, am I live now? Hello?
This caller is listening to the video, the live broadcast. That is what he's listening to. And he wants to hear it also from here. That is not how to, when you call, you off the video you are watching, then you speak to me direct. That is how it is done. You can't be listening to it and listening to here. And you'll be saying, hello, hello, hello. I want to call back somebody that wanted to call. And then I think this, our sister, wants to speak to us.
Hello.
Welcome to the program, I see the heart. We are live.
Hello, we go talk, I see the heart. Now we will take talk. My name is Evangelist Chidimma.
Thank you.
Let me tell you something. Uche Mofo is an employee to Biafran's, is an employee in Biafran's struggle. And another employee that paid him higher has employed him, and he answered them. Uche Mofo is not a freedom fighter. Let me tell you something. Uche Mofo is so greedy, and Uche Mofo is even in Nnamdi Kanu, but people does not know this. And now they paid Uche Mofo a huge amount of money to bring Nnamdi Kanu down, because the thing that followers of Nnamdi Kanu will follow Uche Mofo. When Uche Mofo come out and said anything against Nnamdi Kanu, but you don't know that Chukwu Okike Abiama bring Nnamdi Kanu out for this struggle. They don't know who Nnamdi Kanu is. When they see him in spiritual realm, they will know who he is. Nnamdi Kanu is not ordinary person that you can touch with and go away. God is with him. I saw Nnamdi Kanu, an angel God surround him. Nnamdi Kanu is in the middle like an egg. Then whatever they are doing is rubbish. Uche Mofo, all the blood of the innocent one that lost in Biafra land, they will fight Uche Mofo. Watch Darlington and see what is going to happen to Uche Mofo. Uche Mofo will surely pay. This is all I want to contribute.
Thank you so much.
God bless you. I thank you for all your effort. Bye.
Thank you. Oh my God, I love our mothers too much. When they speak, I am happy because they are the people that knows the pains of child bearing. They are the people that have what is called child bearing problem. They have it. We are the men. Our own is to make sure that we provide food, but the mothers are the people that carries the baby and takes care of them. And when you kill one of their child, they knows exactly what they passed through 9 months, and even at the point of giving birth. So when they call on my program and make their contribution, I am also happy. So as in the heart, Naso de Tokam, all of you that want to contribute to this program, it is time for you to call. When you call, I will answer your call. Some of you that have called, I may return your call back. So stay tuned, for I may return your call. Before the word is speaking against you. That is how God of the land will also speak against you. If you are still there watching, pick up your call. And your number end with 43. I see the heart. Welcome to the program.
Morning. I see the heart. I see the program.
Go ahead, please. You have only about 2 minutes to round up. Go ahead.
Yeah. My name is Peter. I'm calling from Deutschland.
Go ahead, Mr. Peter.
I just want to thank you, my brother.
Thank
you. I think you are doing a great job. Okoma.
Thank you.
God sends me you. Guide you. You are doing a great job.
Thank you, brother.
I don't have much to say. I just want to encourage all the Biafrans, the genuine ones, all over the world, that they should remain focused, resolute. They should forget about Uchuma for as the answer is the masters that we have been bought. But what all to him, that all the blood of people that have died in this struggle, will torment him until he confess. And you know, this like the this last the prophet last right he said, Uche Mofo is envious of Nnamdi Kanu, but many people have not noticed it. You know, that's why you know he's trying to. So May God, I pray that God will continue to strengthen man, if not man. Wherever he is, let him remain strong. We are behind him. Nothing will happen to him. It's only that people don't know where the man's man can. They are thinking that man is another person. He's not another person. He can't dare him and go free. If they don't know him, they are seeing him as he's not my following person. So to call this short, I just want to, why I call that, we should find a way to talk to our women, you know, that those ones that are very important, you know, many people are affected by this this info guy, which is my fault. We should find a way to talk to them, you know.
There's no problem. There's no problem. Thank you, my brother. Thank you, my brother. There's no problem. I'm going to host a program for Biafra women worldwide.
Yeah.
It's going to be a powerful program for Biafran women worldwide. I will host them. I will give them 2 hours to speak on this program. As long as you're a woman, you call. Yeah, I'm call. Of course, I will do that. Thank
our
you.
Women are wonderful. Which of us is an evil person? And his wife is also an evil woman.
Of course.
That's, his wife is a demon. Which of us is also a demon. So, my brother, thank you. Thank May God bless you and bless Onyem.
He said, thank you. And Obi Udobienu is another evil man. Okay, Yarurala, who is behind Uchemefo? Obi Udobienu is another evil man. Okay, Yarurala, who is behind Uchemefo? But I don't want to open his chapter for now. I do not want to open his chapter for now. The line is still open. Those that want to call 0708126-9808 is the number to call on WhatsApp. If you call, we are going to answer your call and put you in line so that you can speak and the whole world will hear you. We are live on Radio Biafra. We are right on Radio Biafra London 2. We are live on Biafra TV. We are live on Aside Hot Biafra TV. We are live on Prince Darlington's World. We are live on Mazo Beleze. We are live on IPOB Community Radio. We are live in so many platforms right now. And whatever your contribution is, bring it for the world will hear you. Hello, welcome to the program. I see the host.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Yeah, I see the host. So I want to come.
Go ahead, please. Be audible. Okay. Be audible. I start. Speak louder.
Before I start, I want to ask a question. I know you are a member of my group, and I know you are a student from London. But I want to know when you join IPOB, please don't be angry.
You say you want to know what?
When you join IPOB.
This question, is it relevant? Is it important that I must answer it?
No, I just want to ask because I joined IPOB in 2013 and I'm still a member of IPOB.
Okay.
I just want to
know. Okay, okay. Well, the truth is that I joined 2011/12. Listen, 2012 IPOB was active, but from 2011 I was listening to Mazen Nandekan on shortwave.
So what I want to say, nobody, I'm not supporting what is the future report. But the fact is that if our leader Marvin Nandekalo came up tomorrow and said something to the people, maybe they have reconciled. Or maybe Uchemefo has been welcomed back in the struggle. So how will all these brokers and all these cutting of things will be? But I know how both of them were and how.
Wait, let me answer you. Let me answer you. Did you listen to this program from beginning?
I listened to you from beginning, but I thought at the moment that I was working.
Okay, you started listening from beginning.
Yeah, but I listened to you also two days ago.
No, forget about 2 days ago. We are talking about this particular program. Did you listen from beginning?
I listened to you for the first 5 minutes before I went back. I was working.
Okay.
I started again.
Okay. I would implore you to go and listen to it full before you come and ask this question. Because if you listen to it from beginning to the end, you will not ask this question. Because the committee that was set up, maybe you didn't hear that part, which Father Odimegwa headed, that wanted to make peace resolution between Mazina Nekano and the Uche Mefo. They contacted Uche Mefo. Uche Mefo said his anger. They contacted Mazina Nekano. Mazina Nekano said his own. They now say they are going to bring two of them together. Mazina Nekano say yes, bring us together. Let us talk about this thing. Let us settle this case. If Mazina Nekano is at fault, he will beg Uche Mefo to forgive. But if Uche Mefo is at fault, Uche Mefo should beg so that we can continue. Then Uche Mefo said no. Did you hear that part?
You know,
yes or no? Yes or no? Yes or no? Did you hear that part?
I have not said about the father
too, but I no. If you did not hear this, that's what I'm saying. Some people will wake up, you just wake up and you begin to talk and ask some question that is not important. This question he asked now is not important. Because Uche Mefo have tendered his resignation letter. Listen, it is not. Hold on. Uche Mefo tendered his resignation letter. And Mazina Nekano rejected it. He tendered it again. Mazina Nekano rejected it. Mazina Nekano wanted to make peace with him. He refused. He wanted to host his Zoom call. And the people who want to settle them said, please stop. Don't do it. Don't. He said no. He went ahead and do it and called Mazina Nekano a liar. Now, after saying all this, do you think that Mazina Nekano can come back? The Mazina Nekano that you know, in as much as say you joined the struggle in 2013, do you think the Mazina Nekano that you know we go back to somebody who have betrayed the struggle to this extent? Yes or no?
You know why I said it?
Yes or no, then you give me a reason.
In 3 weeks or 4 weeks, there will be more other than what is happening in Nigeria. And the most of those people are different. And he has never said anything or utter any statement.
That means you didn't... Brother, go and listen to this broadcast again. Then after you can come up. Thank you. I don't want people who will come and distract us and take our time. You can't come and be taking our airtime, talking nonsense. Welcome to the program, Aside Hot.
Hello?
Welcome to the program, Aside Hot. Hello? Hello?
Yes, this is Origina Ama. Hello?
Greet us in our usual way, then you go ahead and tell us what you want to say.
My name is Ahmad Ambone. Yeah, I am an IPOB in Italy. Thank you for picking my call. I sent you a message.
Hold on, madam. I say you have not greeted us. Yes, there is a symbol we have here. The remark.
I said good morning. Good morning. I don't know about your symbol. I said good morning. No, that good morning is general greeting.
No, it's
in
not.
In Biafra land, in everywhere.
It's not. As it hot, that's how I go talk. As it hot is truth. Truth is very hot. And on this program, you have to tell us that.
Then the symbol, okay, as it yes. hot.
That's how you go talk.
I come to talk my own opinion.
Thank you. Go ahead.
Okay. I listened to your live video this morning. I was there and I do follow you all. But what I want to say is that, is it your right to bring about what they talk in the meeting? Is it your right to do that?
I don't understand you.
I am asking you a question. Because the person that just finished calling now, you are telling the person asks you question. You say something. I don't remember what you are like trying to answer the person. But I am asking you question now. It is Onyisi and the community that set up a meeting, this meeting. Is it your own right to come and talk something about that meeting? Why can't you let Onyisi address
it? Can you allow me to answer you?
Yeah.
You will not ask question and answer it at the same time. That is the problem of our people. First and foremost, I want to answer you correctly and directly. I don't want to mince word. The voice of the meeting was played on Radio Biafra London. That voice that you're listening to right now was hosted by Ikechukwu, one of our broadcasters from Middle East. So I now pick it up to play it on my own platform because there are people who we are not privileged to listen to it on Radio Biafra London. So are you okay with that now, with that answer?
Mm. Okay, I am okay with that because they have already made it live.
Okay.
Okay, now, as you are an IPOB, because I know that you are an IPOB, you are an IPOB, you are in Biafra. Is that how you're supposed to handle this, your live broadcast? Castigating one person and left one person. Is that how it's done?
Okay. How
like
do you,
maybe now, no. If you have a problem in your family and they invite you to come and bring peace in that family, is that how you're supposed to castigate people? Maybe one person and leave the other person.
Excuse me. What do you mean by castigating one person? Can you elaborate? Can you
throw more light? Castigating is not good.
Okay.
You have
hold
to
on.
Tell people
hold on.
About the way forward. I preach you for the peace.
Hold on.
Not this kind of video you are hosting right now.
Hold on, madam. Hold on. You are taking more than time, but I will give you more time so that I will iron things out. Because when you speak, I know from the channel where you're coming from. Now, you say I'm castigating Uche before and I leave Mazen Nandikano. Did you listen to this program from beginning to now before you call? Yes or no?
I said yes. I follow up.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Did you hear the Reverend Father say that there was a committee that wanted to make peace and Uche before refused? Did you hear it or not?
Yes, I heard the Reverend Father saying that he interviewed Uche before and the Mazen Nandikano.
Okay.
He wanted to bring two of them together.
Okay.
Uche before refused.
Thank you. Then
and
bye.
The
bye.
Mazen Nandikano accept to bring them together. I listen to all those things.
Then bye. Bye-bye. I have answered you. And thank God you are confirming what you heard. So people like you, I know how to handle your case. And I've answered you. Welcome to the program, Aside Hot.
Hello, Aside Hot. Now, so I want to talk.
Go ahead, my brother. Go
I'm
ahead.
Calling from yeah, I'm calling from Holland.
Aside Hot, please tell us your name.
My name is Charles. Oh, no, yeah. I'm calling from Holland.
Go ahead.
Yes, brother. I want to say something like this. If the Reverend Father has called both parties, our leader, Nandikano, and Uche Mefo, for them to come to make peace, and our leader agreed to all them, again, Mefo did not agree.
Mm-hmm.
I don't see the reason why we come on every day discussing about Uche Mefo, discussing every day about him. You are making him more powerful. You are making him more that if without him, that we cannot move on.
No.
So if we can forget about him and move on and look for a way we can,
Hold on. I want to say. No, your contribution is your opinion, and I allow you to hold there to read. But listen to me. Ndeba is no good. Emefoho oko tele. Amanla, emefoko tele yala. I am not making Uche Mefo any popular. Biafra is over 75 to 80 million people, and out of these 75 to 80 million people, about let me say. 40 something million people are listening to Radio Biafra, and it is not everybody that listens to Radio Biafra every day. The story you hear from Radio Biafra today, you may not even have the privilege to listen to it tomorrow or next tomorrow. I don't know whether you understand what I'm saying. What you hear from Radio Biafra today may not be said tomorrow, it may not be said the next tomorrow, and this is a damage that will be caused by somebody. The people that heard all what Uche Mefo said in that Zoom meeting and called Mazen Nandikano name and said that he's a liar may not even have privilege to listen again to know what happened. That is why I have to repeat it over and over and over and over and over again, so that if they didn't hear it today, they will hear it tomorrow. If they didn't hear it tomorrow, they will hear it next tomorrow. As long as I'm concerned, Uche Mefo is not dragging any struggle down, but he thought he had the power to do that. So I am not making, he's already popular as the former deputy of Indigenous People of Biafra. And trying to bring the struggle back is something that I cannot keep quiet and watch him do. So what we need to do is, the way Mazen Nandikano started preaching us from the beginning, and people were calling him chief, people were calling him 419, people were calling him so many names, If you're following Mazenandi Kanu from the beginning, you know that people have called him so many names. But at a time, they begin to believe him. They begin to see that what this man is saying is true, that he's not a thief. Is it true or false? So this is how it works in a community, in a society whereby everybody is intelligent, everybody is knowledgeable. So if you don't keep repeating that thing that is causing problem and making people to see reason why you are doing what you are doing, if you say it once and you didn't say it again, people will hear only that one that you say. They will not hear. For example, if somebody call you a thief in the public and later you are found not being a thief, you are not found guilty of stealing anything, there are people that have heard that moment that he called you a thief, and those people will not be there when you have been not found guilty of being a thief. But I don't know if I want you, but mom and I want you to know, you understand what I'm trying to say. So those people that they heard, those people that heard you, that heard that you were a thief, will not be there when they will declare you innocent that you're not a thief. And those people, they will start peddling lies, carrying your name, going up and down, saying that you're a thief. So for you to vindicate yourself, you have to continually saying the truth, that you are being vindicated, that you have not done this, until it will now get into the mindset of those people that heard when you are called a thief. So Uchemefo, me talking about him is not dragging anything back. We have so many people who are broadcasting talking about Uchemefo, and I am allowed to use this platform, this hello platform, to speak about all the truth of what is happening, because I am saying the truth and nothing but the truth. So thank you so much, my brother.
Yes, man. You know, if we will continue to talk about this issue, our enemies, they will be, you know, laughing at us and, you know, thinking that maybe our troubles no more going on. So let's forget about this.
No, it's your opinion. It's your opinion. Let me correct you again. Brother. Yes, brother Wanganzi. Listen to me. Listen to me. Let me correct you before you go. Brother, let me tell you something. Are you a Christian?
Most of us
are like that. Now let me tell you.
Yeah.
Let me tell you this. Do you know that when God wants to elevate you, he will deflate you first? Do you know that?
Yes.
If God wants to elevate you, he will deflate you first. If God wants to strengthen you, to put you in a position that you have never been before, he will first bring you down. Do you know why he's doing that? He's doing that because he wants to take the glory alone. From when you are down, when everybody has deserted you, when nobody is there for you, then he will not catapult you to that position where he wants you to be. Because such a good to not near. Nihinka, whatever that is happening now, this is the right time. It is happening. And Mazenan can do those that in weeks to come, that we are going to see what will happen. That is going to be very tough. And that toughness, and listen, brother. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. So that toughness is what we are facing now. And as it hurts, that's what we can talk about. Yes, welcome to the program once again. You called before and you are not listening to me. You are listening to the voice.
Hello.
Yes, hello. Welcome to the program.
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
As the hurt, that's how I'm talking.
Go ahead and tell us your name.
What I'm trying to say is this. Hello?
Tell us your name, please. Yes, you see, he is still listening to the voice. I don't know why our people are like this. I told you when you call, once I answer your call, then you do what? You stop. You stop from the device you are watching or you are listening to. Then you talk to me direct. That is how it's supposed to be. Now I want to respond to Ama, the woman that called me before. If you're listening to this program from the beginning and you have the effort to come and say that I am castigating Uchemefo, you know, leaving Mazen Nnamdi Kanu, you are not saying the truth to yourself. Hello, welcome to the program. Hold on, please. Please, just hold on. Stay where you are, please. Stay where you are. If you are listening to this program and you say I'm castigating Uchemefo, having known fully that Uchemefo refused to make peace with our leader, Uchemefo refused to make peace, and the Uchemefo was the admin handling Radio Biafra app alone. And when Mazen Nnamdi Kanu is on Facebook Live, then Lelo Biafra would be playing another thing. Why Mazen and Kadi is saying another thing? Once you know all these things and you heard it and you know the truth and you refuse to say the truth, here is not where you come to defend UTMFO, because you don't have any fact about UTMFO. We have the fact and figures of all he have done, and we are giving it to you. It's either you take it or you leave it. So please, my brother, as you heard, go ahead and make a contribution.
Okay. As you heard, my contributions.
Your name, tell us your name, please. Tell us your name.
My name is Ekere.
Okay, go ahead, Ekere. Go ahead, Mazudoka, go ahead.
Yeah, there are somebody that called that asked a question, but I just want to also from there ask that question, because you know why that person asked that, you know, I understand. Who should have fought? Yes. When you understand the sky is there, he never said that they should broadcast it in the meetings that they have. And they see it that they set up, somebody said it over there, went out to broadcast it over there. When you people listen to that thing critically, you will know that you can never cause who have the car for what. He never agreed. What he said that he did say the truth. Liar. That was the only thing people started holding. And they, okay, they have not to have a peace talk about this issue and who can report the truth. Who can report hold a broadcast 2 days ago? He never dare try to castigate as in Nandekano. What he is accusing also is people who have broadcasted as the DOS. I don't know how Mutemefo hold this organization on when Nandekano was in prison. Even how they started this radio program, Mutemefo also, even as Nandekano explained how they, even he was living in a car before, even they don't have anything that is Mutemefo that supported him. This song was because this song, everything is started like this. You know why we are saying this? Even if they want to abolish that seat, they should not treat Uche before that way. I am not against Uche before. I am not against Mazi. We are all IPOC
members. Excuse me. Mm-hmm. Excuse me. Hold on. You have taken. Yes. You are now on 3 minutes. I allow you to speak for 3 minutes, and it is time for me to respond to you. And I'm hearing my voice back. I would like you to close the channel where you are watching me or listening to me. Then listen to me direct from this place, so it will not be distracting what you are saying. I heard your point, yes, and I know you have come to defend Uche before. And I want to tell you one thing: I respect your opinion. You have right to follow whoever you want to follow. You have right to say whatever you want to say. And I am out. I can't stop you. And I like to discuss with people who listen. As I say, wait, you wait, and I'm talking. Because I was listening to you. Utemefo, what is the reason why he refused to make peace with Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu? Can you tell me? Do you know?
Let me answer you. Because if I ask you now, I'm not defending Utemefo. Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu is our leader. Can you answer my question?
Why did he refuse? If Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu love us, love the movement. Love the movement and acknowledge the death of the people that have died in the struggle and put it before every other thing. What makes him to say no? He can't make peace with Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu. When Mazenan can say, no, yes, I am ready to make peace with you. And if I'm at fault, I will apologize. If you're at fault, you should apologize. Why did Utemefo say no? What makes you think that he refused to make peace? Ocho Kabowasaga, why? Answer that question.
Did you hear what I said? They wanted to have a peace talk. And Utemefo did not respond to the peace.
Why? Talk. Why?
Wait, Utemefo is the second command to.
Sorry, you are not here. You have taken more than time. I'm giving people 2 minutes, but I've given you 4 minutes plus, and yet you cannot make any reasonable sense here. You couldn't make any reasonable sense here. You come to defend Uche before, after hearing all what he have done, after hearing that he have refused to make peace with Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu, you still have the nerve to come here and be taking our airtime. Are you buying me airtime? Do you know that I'm burning for now to speak to Biafrans? And you come here and you're taking our airtime, talking nonsense. This is around nonsense. You want peace. You want them to make peace. You don't want me to be talking about Mefo. Yes. And you're even defending that you listen to him. Why did he go and open radio? That he didn't, he only said that Mazen and Khan was lying against him. And you have the effrontery to come here and be talking rubbish. I don't answer this kind of call, but once I answer you, I ask you a question. Since you can't answer me, I cut you off. Welcome to the program, caller on WhatsApp.
Hello.
Welcome to the program.
Good morning from Mazi Chukubi Kim.
Welcome to the
program.
Go ahead, my dear sister. And please be audible, be louder.
Oh, hey, Biafra.
Biafra, we hear you.
Concerning this Uche Mofo matter, I don't want us to make Uche Mofo popular.
No, he's already
he's popular.
He has already made himself popular
now.
Yes, he's already made himself popular.
In a negative way.
Yeah.
Hello.
Go ahead.
As in the heart.
Go ahead. Talk as in the heart. Go ahead.
Yeah. Make her ask this woman where they call her Amaga Bonnie. Amaga come from this platform now. They talk, say, why we no let our leader come talk this thing? Ama, you know they hear the broadcast who Uche Mofo they make this way. Where he say he don't resign, come up by IPOC. He don't come out as deputy leader. You know they hear him.
Okay.
You see, say this thing where they do, now saga what you they do for Facebook. Eh? If he say this way, then they address here, now the saga what you they do for Facebook.
Tell him. You say follow. You are follow woman.
If you say that you say that is what this thing happened. What the man didn't the color don't come and talk. Now they say you where the useless woman they call your face, they say man didn't the color come and come to talk. Eh? This woman, when do they respect herself? If you say this to my father,
follow him.
Because what else you need to stop for you, what is I'm not a phone, you know, stop.
Thank you. God bless you. Ama, I think your fellow woman have responded to you. And if you think say you get the IPOB is the saga you are doing on Facebook, your fellow women, I think women are calling again. Welcome again. Welcome to the Asidi Hawks.
I beg my brother, Lord,
People are writing now about her. I don't even know her.
She has listened to this book to the Christ.
Can you imagine?
They say they are toxic. They have listened to what the Reverend Father said from X to Z. She still has the courage to talk rubbish. They are sick. Talk about a mayor, of course, and we got to know exactly how we said, but to the end of you for this one. And if you get it for this one, but you are able to be anger. Let her be careful what she's saying, because none of them can be compared with the Nandekano.
Even the three pastors that are stand alone and all put there are not stopping. They didn't want to hook us.
They want to bring
so that the daughters of the land, the daughters of the land will not make us content.
They want to bring their dirty linens and watch it on this program, and I will help them out. Thank you. Amma, you are listening. Your fellow women are responding to you, not me. Because I don't want to insult you. You are listening. You know, go second on Facebook. Feel only guy then I IPO. Thank you very much, my sister. God bless you. Yeah? Thank you. I see the hot now, so they talk. Hello. Yes, sir. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Oh my God, it's getting hotter. Welcome to the program. I see the hot.
Yeah, hello. What? I see the hot. One naked lemon. One more. I want Uchenna. I'm calling from Europe.
Go ahead.
And I'm making a Ana mekele ndị niile lanụ ụlọ anyị, ndị si ha ga-eji eziokwu nọgide na ihe niile anyị na-eme. Ịma pepin chọrọ ịgwa pepụ onye bụla mekwara si ndị ihe mere depụta anyị ji efọ uche mefọ pụta ka god si mee ya ka ọ dịrị bikos is beta na we are in the front of the gate to know our enemy. Chineke ji ya lụọra na ndị ka lụọlụ ka ọ gwụ ya si ndị ya na ya nọ on the union, because in that Bible I go in that Bible I go back up and the Jesus Christ is here for child and don't mention everything won't be really a little bit Allah worship here. No one knows how the thing come everything better how come more to no men this problem after that you jack here who we are local when you shine your motor you see me at person you chill as on here but I think you may be going but then I tell you I'm in a man made a new one I'm in a job made a new one. When you're black for the right choice, you be after a great group for our own time. When now you say to him more, I am a drop for the Bible, put the Jabra. I may have with him one. I may joke and the more who by whom I can make it 81.
You
said, when the calendar joke, whom I can't, I'm a mere 80 boy. You said, I'm a very young man, I'm a young man.
You talk about it. I see the hot, I saw the talk, and I never remember as well as you came. Look at the program that I wanted to end in 2 hours. Now it's getting to 3 hours, and our people are still calling. People are angry. Welcome to the program, I see the hot.
Yeah, hello?
Welcome to the program, I see the hot.
Yeah, I see the hot. Now, so I want to talk more.
Go ahead and tell us, I see the hot, and tell us your name. Hi, our women are calling. Our women are calling.
I'm calling from Kuala Lumpur.
Please be fast, eh? I give you 2 minutes. Our women are calling. I want to pick all their calls. Go ahead.
Okay. Bros, regarding to what we are discussing,
yes,
concerning this brother Uchemefo, this is not issue that everybody will be broadcasting online. They are promoting Uchemefo. There is a way to silence this particular person. With obedience, it's not on broadcast or whatever. Now, silent paper, we collect that paper for UK. We what they do, they in diaspora for years know how to spoil the asylum paper, which Mazin know how to do it. So all these things we are fighting this. That's a way to treat such person. So make all like, give us authority. Make us spoil the asylum paper. Make them send them back to Niger. If you go Niger, they go finish up.
Okay,
so all these things where people they come, they talk, this person they talk, will not take them as anything. Make it go back to Nigeria, join the Nigerian government, pay the politics of APC and PDP.
Thank you.
So that you go come off our road.
Thank you. Thank you for your contribution. But I want you to know that we are not making him any popular. We are only doing justice to what he has done, and we must continue doing justice. Welcome as in the heart. Please lower the volume of the set you are watching me with, please, and speak to the world.
Hello.
Welcome to the program.
Good afternoon.
I'm after
the
hall. And I saw you go ahead, my dear sister, and tell us your name.
Because I'm from London,
okay.
Biko, I've been hearing from you, you've been doing a very good job, and
go ahead, the world is listening. Go ahead, Okotro off, the world is listening.
Okay, so I've been with you and I've been following you up, and you've been doing a very great job. I've just heard about everything which is for this. Anybody that will stand on that ground or to believe what Uchimefo is saying or to support him, I don't think life will be fair with that person.
You see?
Because Anao, Onyedugindia, Ndi Esereya, I've not seen anything wrong Mazin and the Carlo has done. No one has joke with you, honestly. He's been telling us the truth and we've been following him because no one joke with you. Which we have just told Miss Mazin and the Carlo out. But God, who is watching, God, who has been with us, and God, who will never abandon us, will keep protecting him. Because all these things are unbelievable. They are unbelievable. That if he can humble him and ask him to call on a round table, because he is putting his table up.
Yes.
Most people are just there being selfish. They are killing people, people's blood are being scattered everywhere.
Yes.
Mandekal is considering that. Because he's not allowed to provide his table.
Of course. Of course,
he can afford his being so selfish. And trying to, after I'm called you for, I won't be able. After I'm called you for, only watching a permanent. That many are shopping in the around table.
Thank you. Thank you. That's the point. That's the point.
Yeah, it's an oracle.
Yes.
Oh, you didn't even know that oracle. I don't know what I mean.
Yes.
What comes to join you? Is going to go on my ass? No,
you're right.
What comes to join you? If they are not able to call you, come on, no one will be in a
Yes.
Oh, yeah, Fargo.
Of course.
That is why he cannot come to trouble with his kinsmen again.
Yes, of course. Go ahead.
May God have mercy upon him. Oh, many men are following me. Many men are following me. We shall live and go. But our next generation, we still remember him.
That is it. Thank you.
My brother.
Thank you so much.
Keep your program beating.
Okay.
I'm not going to go.
Thank
and
you.
And God will give us the answer. Generation.
He said, and again, I would like you to do something for us. Can you hear me, madam?
Yes.
I hope you are a member of IPOB Woman Wing in London, right?
I have not registered.
Why now?
If I can use the link, I will. My husband also is a very strong member of IPOB.
So that if your husband is a member, your husband can help you. So what I want you to do is, once you join the family, and I am going to host a program that only women, I want our mothers to speak on this matter. Because our mother have not properly given the chance to speak, because they are the people that begat us. They know the pain of what childbearing is. And the losing child, they equally know what it is. It's not as if men doesn't know, but you people bear more of the pain. So I would like to host a program whereby I will host IPOB women worldwide. They are going to call on my program and we have to talk on this particular issue, because I believe that anything you are doing without women, one day, other balance. So thank you so much. When it will happen, keep your eye on my wall. I will have to, update it maybe a day before the program, so that only women will call on the program and they will have to do what to do justice to what is happening. God bless you, my sister. Thank you. Yes, as in the hot, so they talk, so many calls are coming in. Any call that comes in now, I am going to answer. And I've just answered another one. Yes, welcome to the program, as in the hot. Stop listening to your voice to the gadget. I keep saying this thing, please. Talk to me direct. Mm-hmm. Answer their call. Hello, welcome to the program, as in the hot.
Go ahead, my dear sister. Good afternoon. Your name and where you're calling
from? My name is Adeze. I'm calling from Scotland.
Go ahead, Adeze.
I will follow you and I will hear what you talk since morning. I'm not feeling fine. Don't mind the way I'm talking.
Okay.
But what you make, I won't talk this because of Amagabon. That Amagabon where they carry mass, they come put for, with no concern. What is she know about Uchemefo and Mazen and the Kano? She not listening to this program from the beginning. She not hear from the Reverend Father. She can't ask to say you decide one side, leave one side. So which one side will you decide, leave one side? Amagabon makes she mind herself. I think one program where she make is for other 3 days ago. And all the program where she make now about Mazen and the Kano. Make Mazen and the Kano come and can't explain. If you know explain, we go know say what in this person is talking and do. Make she mind herself. Mazen and the Kano know be her mate. Who built your mate for? Who's the phone now? What can you not do for us for this Biafra struggle? If you won't go, make him go a bed. What can you, we don't even need him again.
He's gone. He's devil. Not if you won't go, he's gone.
Phone devil.
He's gone already. He's gone already.
Now, imagine that the Carlos Sakam, not even sack himself.
Thank you.
So, what you can't consign, imagine the Carlos consignment. People know the reason well. Say, imagine that, okay, they never hear from imagine the Carlos. Why they can't they believe what him, which of my phone talk?
Okay.
Now, Reverend Father, where God will then, where the lesson, Reverend Father, don't come and come talk. They're not going to listen to that one where they, and that myself, I think, saying I'm making up from the Anambra. And this is a bring up for the gospel. Imagine the kind of name was taken. This person, Anambra, all the Anambra to begin the talk of rubbish for Facebook. I they see them. What they consign, they have a Anambra consign, they consign their state. Then they crazy. Make it, Amagabon, no contact that nonsense again. Making not talk that nonsense again. Then they do like they support my plan for back. They talk nonsense.
Thank you, my sister.
Get out. You don't need him again.
Thank you. And get ready for Biafra Women program that I will host very soon.
No okay? Problem. Yeah. No problem.
Just keep your eyes watching.
Thank you, my brother.
Thank you. Thank you. Hey, I see they hot. So they talk. I'm at the body. Don't hear her. Our women say make you carry a saga come out. Say this is not Facebook saga. This is IPO. We are talking about a country. We are not talking about gossip here. Welcome to the program, as in the Lord.
As in the Lord. I said I want to talk more.
Go ahead, my brother.
Mazi Chukwemeka. I'm calling from Pakistan. Mazi Chukwemeka.
Go ahead, Mazi Chukwemeka.
So, you have 2 minutes. Brother, there is no need of dragon. If you can remember always, our leader used to say, when he be in back of that microphone, anything he talk must come to pass.
That's
therefore, never understand that. People thinking that thing he's talking is just ordinary. No. And he's always saying it. He only needs 100 men can bring Biafra.
That's correct.
He's always saying it. But that word, people don't know the meaning. People don't know the meaning. All these things are happening now. Is time. Time is coming. Is approaching.
Yes.
Now, the we know the difference of grass. Between the grass and into the farm. So now they're going to select and remove all the grasses and leave the main crops in the farm. It's what is happening now. So people should not start to talk like that. The whole prophecy, everything they talk must be an amazing. Okay, that man, that guy, people never knew who he is. Prophets, it's a better, and I have here for you, the two on the outside. Now, man, when you have then a nukte mother, a big prophet. So, what people church here? On a queer, never hand up behind that microphone. He said, obviously, no one is well. No, inspiration from a bull to go to through him. But you hear na how they go, na decha, na
mezu. Please round up, please round up, round up, round up, round up.
Only 100 men.
Round up, round up, please.
We blame Biafra. The people, this is not even enough. People are not sorry. Everybody should keep quiet. Can you just make you to see the case each other? Come as well. I say, Apollo. Yeah, you repeat it, Apollo.
Please.
God will select the people who will do the job.
Round up, brother, please, round up.
So,
please.
If I was in the media, who is him?
Thank you.
Thank you. Only if we're going to make broadcast, and that's 1 million. Yeah, because
you have to conclude.
I'm not going to be going on a long week this week. One woman who will run a mafia popular.
Thank you, please. I have a lot of calls to answer. Our women, whenever I see a picture of a woman, I would like to
ask.
Good morning, welcome. Go ahead, my mother, go ahead.
That's what I want to ask Uchemefo. Uchemefo said that Marvin Nandekani is a liar. Is he telling me that since he was born, he has never told a lie? Is that what he's saying or what?
No, which lie did Marvin Nandekani
tell? And the other thing, what?
No, which lie did he told? Which lie? Listen, my sister, before you continue. Marvin Nandekani said that our radio Biafra app have been hijacked by the Zulu government. That was what he said. Now, Uchemefo is the only one that has password. The only admin has password to that application. No other person does. Now, if Mazen Nankan is on live Facebook speaking to the world, the app will be playing music. So, and he said that it has been hijacked. That means that is either somebody have sold out and doing something with the app, or somebody have hijacked the app, or what they call it, or hacked the app. So he is still 100% correct. Now, because Uchemefo is the only one that have access to the app, he felt offended. That is why he said that Mazen Nandekani is lying, trying to defend himself. So continue and go ahead, my dear sister.
Okay, now he said he is a liar.
Yeah.
And another thing is this. What is his purpose? What is he trying to achieve by telling people he's a liar? Is he trying to condemn their mind towards Marvin Nandekani? Or is he trying to circulate between two of them? Because I don't understand what he meant by telling those people that thing.
No.
Because I don't know if they expect Marvin Nandekani to be called.
No.
That he will not make a mistake.
Now, his name is Rezo Uchemefo. Rezo Uchemefo, that is his name. He said that he is a Rezo. That if you want to cut somebody that is going to cut you deep, the post is on his wall, you can go and see it there. Now, what he's doing is to cut Nandekani and cut IPOB because this is the job that he was paid for. Come and do this work. That is why the Reverend Father wanted to make peace between him and Mazen Nandekani, and he refused. Not only Reverend Father, they were a group of people. They came together. And he refused. He said he doesn't want peace. So that is why he went ahead to court as he promised to court. So that is it. So round up, my sister, so that I can answer more calls.
Now again, Uchemefo, people take order from you. Why is it that when Mazen Nandekani told you to give another person that pill, you refuse to do it and you're asking why? Does it mean that when you give other people order, they ask you why? Why was he supposed to give that person the password? It's an order.
And
you obey your own order.
Thank you.
Why can't you obey Mazen Nandekami's own order?
Thank you, my sister. Thank you. And the reason why Hold on, 1 minute. Before you round up. The reason why Mazen asked for that pin, for that password, is because the app had been compromised. And Mefo is the only person that have the password. The app is saying another thing when Mazi is saying another thing. Sometimes the app will be off when Mazi is live. So he have the right to ask for the password so that he will look into what is happening. So continue, a round up, please.
Isn't there nothing? Isn't there nothing? What happened? is an order given to you. You have to give it to him.
Of course.
Because you give everybody order, they obey you. Why can't you obey the person that gave you order?
Thank you.
Does it mean that you are telling us to do something, but you are not doing it yourself?
Okay.
So the final one is this. Does it mean that it's only when he's handling Radio Biafra that he'll be in for this struggle? Is that what he's trying to let us know?
That is only where he can work.
Does it mean that he's handling the password? He wants to be managing it himself. Is that why he's in this struggle? Is that the point he's trying to let us know? Because I've been thinking about all these things that he said himself. I've not heard from Marvin Alikar, but I'm judging him according to what he says. He said they eliminated him by asking, did you know about the community radio app? You are taking order. There are things that you don't need to know. You are hustling. You are out for struggling about Biafra. There are things that you are not meant to know. Just take order, obey order, like you're telling, like they used to say, if I got on the man, then the same thing, likewise, if I got on the man, it must not mean that you know everything. So, as he gives the order, you take the order. Does it mean that you're telling order because you've given out the password, you cannot be in the struggle again? That humiliates you. What about others that have died fighting for those people?
Thank you,
what
my dear sister. Please round up. Please round up. I have matched 3 hours now. Please round up, my dear sister, okay?
That's what I have to say.
Thank you so much. And get ready. Get ready for IPOB Women program that I'm going to host. So I will update my world. All of you, I want all of you to call and speak to HMFO. Thank you. God bless you. Hi. Oh my God. I see the hot. The line is too hot, man. This call may be the last call that I will answer for today. Maybe the last one. Yes. Welcome to the program. Lower the volume of the gadget you are watching me with, please. Go ahead. 2 minutes only.
Good morning. My name is Uchenna, calling from London.
Go ahead, Mr. Uchenna.
This matter, what I want to say here is everybody has got their price tag. You see them with a price, they're the brand there. So, everybody, you all know, in the Nigeria, where you all know, this year, boom. You know, when I go, what I do?
Yes.
So, man, our leader, Mazinon Kalu, was in the prison. They promised him everything. He said to them, you people have not got nothing that can make me to change my stand as a Biafran and to fight for freedom of my people.
Of course.
So, for you to see, this is how to know a freedom fighter.
Yes.
For the fact that you're no longer broadcasting on the radio or whatever it is, that's not what you are there for. You are there for to free your people.
Yes.
Or brought you back to your radio.
Okay. That is all he knows how to do.
Hello?
That is all he knows how to do. Go ahead.
And which he doesn't even know how to do it anyway.
Better.
I never seen him anyway. To be honest.
Beautiful.
When he speaks, to be honest, I'm alone here. When he speaks, I feel like sleeping, to be honest.
Good.
So what he did is a betrayer. Uche Mafo betrayed Biafrans. That's what she'd be saying. He's a betrayer. He betrayed us.
Please round up, my brother.
All right. So even Sabotua, they call him, it's not even enough. He betrayed the struggle. He betrayed us.
Thank you.
He don't want it. For the sake of people that lost their life on this struggle,
he should have made peace.
We have maintained position. Until Biafra comes,
he should have made peace.
What happened, what was going on before all this while.
Round up, please. When I give you signal to round up, I don't want to cut you when you are talking. Round up, please.
I'm not doing the war. If it was during the war, which of all will be a dead man by now? Because we are at war.
That is true.
You can sabotage.
Thank you.
Anyway, we should move on.
Thank you.
Our leader have already told us this. By anybody who knows him
say no, the be saying this.
When I say round up, you round up, please. A lot of people are calling, and I want to also try to bring the program to an end. This is 3 hours plus now. I've been here. Please, when I say round up, you round up. I beg you, please. When I say round up, you have to round up. This is going to be the last caller of the day. You have been calling so many times. Welcome to the program.
Hello.
Welcome to the program. Please, you have only but 2 minutes to round up, please. Thank you. Go ahead. Go ahead and speak to the world. Hello? Yeah, welcome to the program. Please, you are going to be the last caller of this program this morning.
It is not, I hear you, my brother.
Welcome.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon. Yeah.
My brother, I just have to go straight to the point because as I can see, you're busy and I'm not the only one online. I just want to say something. My name is Nkechinyere Joy, aka German Joy Baron. I'm based in Belgium and I'm one of the Mata Belgium.
Beautiful.
What I want to say is very, very, very sharp and short. Whether Uche Mefo wants it or not, whether he likes it or not, he can never be like Nnamdi Kanu. Not even in his grave. Not even something to argue or to, you know, to start competing. Like one of my brother just said, if Uche Mefo is advertising or whatever, I feel like sleeping in so fucking dull to my liking. And from beginning, I told Nnamdi Kanu, this man will betray you. And it has come. And this is how I tell people what is happening today. Since 2016, it will happen. They never believe me. And this is my first time in my life to talk on air with anything pertaining to Biafra. Uche Mefo has disgraced himself, not Nnamdi, not Biafra. He disgraced himself. Uche Mefo was a betrayer a long time ago, but Nnamdi Kanu refused to see him. But I saw him at Mami Water Side. And I'm happy he has disgraced himself by himself. And I'm happy he has gone by himself. And I wish he will go and never come back. Because coming back is to kill him now, the remaining one that he did not achieve to kill is what will come back to kill. Oh, hey, Biafra.
Oh, hey, Biafra. Thank you so much, Ada Biafra. And you guys should get ready for women IPOB mothers program. Please, I cannot answer more calls. Whatever have beginning must have an end. I have tried. It's not easy. For the past 3 hours, I hold a program this early morning, and I'm hosting another one now. And this evening, I will say come on air because we have a lot of issues that we need to bring to your knowledge. A lot of them. Please, all these people that are calling, stop calling because I cannot answer your call anymore. And on this note, let me play this song before I close the program.
Can you get no Nnamdi Kanu, Nnamdi Kanu, Ahmadike
Biafra,
Nnamdi Kanu, Nnamdi Kanu, Ahmadike,
Ujogwele Bulakute,
Nnamdi Kanu, Nnamdi Kanu, Ahmadike,
Ibiafu Kondilo,
Nnamdi Kanu, Nnamdi Kanu, Ahmadike,
Entilo Ina Chosuto,
Nnamdi Kanu, Nnamdi Kanu.
Thank you, Maze Abalanzoye Kokeke, for this beautiful song. I can't stop playing it anytime I come online. My brothers and my sisters, thank you all. And the last caller, thank you so much. German Joy Baron, thank you for your contribution, and thanks to all the women that have called on this program so far, and all the Biafrans that have contributed. You have heard the voice of the Reverend Father, who have exposed what have happened in the secret. You have brought it to the light, to the world, and I'm playing it live for you. You can go back and watch this program all over again so that you can get the knowledge of what has happened, how Mazana Nekanu have even brought himself so low, so humble, promised to apologize to Uchemefo if he is at fault after the whole case is judged. Then if Uchemefo is at fault, Uchemefo should apologize to him. He was ready to make peace because he's a man of peace. He is a prince. For real. And the name of his father, the title of his father is Omudo, his late father, Omudo, one of Afaruku Ibeku, Ewuku, one of Afaruku Ibeku. So he is taken from his father. He is also Omudo. He's a true leader who listened to the voice of his followers. And because of the blood of those people that have shed, because of those people that have died, he is ready to make peace, to make sure that we continue. But Uchemefo, being a devil incarnate he is, being a wicked man he is, with his egocentric syndrome that is disturbing him, he refused to make peace. He went ahead and had his Zoom meeting, and everything burst. And now you people are trying to blame anybody. Before you ask any question or condemn this program or condemn people who are talking about Uchemefo, ask yourself, why did he refuse to make peace? Because you guys are saying, what if Nnamdi Kanu come back tomorrow to say, I want to make peace? It is not going to happen. And then Nnamdi Kanu doesn't even have time to talk about Uchemefo. Biafrans have to do it. It is our duty to do it. Therefore, my brothers and my sisters, the name of this program is Asidi Hot Naso De Tokam. Like our page, Asidi Hot Biafra TV. Subscribe to our YouTube channel, Asidi Hot Biafra TV on YouTube. Just subscribe so that when we come online, when we post things, you will get it. Because it's not everybody that is on Facebook and it's not everybody that is on YouTube. So we need to balance the equation. We have a lot to bring to your table. This evening, I'll be coming online again to give you another beautiful program so that you have the knowledge of what is happening. Some of you, I believe after this morning, we understand that there are things that you need to know that you have known now. Those that are trying to have some kind of double mind, saying, should I continue with this? Since I have not heard from Mazi, which before have spoken and calling him a liar. Could he be a liar? Could he be truth? Now we have known who is a liar between Uchemefo and Mazi Nandekanu. And my name remains Mazi Chukwubike. I salute you all. You guys can see, as I'm doing this program now, my generator got off. Onyona. Onyonanyu. Yes. And I have to continue. And I don't care whether I'm doing this program, or I'm sweating as I'm talking to you right now. That is how it is. So if I cannot fuel my generator, I will not talk to you. That is what we are suffering here. And which before is over there. Galavant, all he cares about is to talk in radio while we are here suffering and doing all we need to do. So my brothers and my sisters, thank you so much. And God bless you. I remain your brother. Once again, I salute you all.